This is a production of SDPB.
Touchdown! This is for a state championship. Oh, direct kick and it's good!
There's going to be some highlights coming off of this.
The short range jumper.
Edging out in lane for the top seed.
This South Dakota High School State Championship event is conducted under the direction of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
Good evening and welcome inside Dakota Bank Center in Brookings for Class A Girls Basketball State Tournament action. I'm Brad DeVere alongside Lisa Bahi, and we are ready for what we hope and we feel will be a couple of good ones. I don't know if they can outdo this afternoon. Those are pretty good basketball games.
A lot of good basketball all throughout the state, but it was great to be here in Dakota Bank. Saw some good basketball.
Yeah. You got. We'll take a look at what we've got coming up tonight. Look at our brackets as we get ready for our first one with the number 2 and the number 7. The Sioux Falls Christian Chargers and the number 7 Hanson Beaverettes. And then, of course, our nightcap, which we talked a little bit about it. Flandreau and T could be a state championship-style game, and they're going to be playing in the first round. So that's just how good this Class A tournament really is, I think. And I think we're in for a treat here the next couple of days.
Yeah, you know, excited to be here and watch some good basketball. And this is, you know, when you come down to this time of season, this is why you play the game.
Yeah, for sure. Everybody's goal is to get here, and now you just kind of let it go. Roll the balls out and let's play. Hanson Beaverettes 17-5, Sioux Falls Christian 20-2. Let's take a look at our two teams in this matchup here tonight to kick things off for our night session. The Beaverettes out of Alexandria, South Dakota, Hanson County. Jim Bridge, Mr. James Bridge, if you will, superintendent, athletic director, girls basketball coach in his 38th season. We'll talk more about him as we go. 94, the enrollment, they're just at the bottom of that Class A, about 4 students above that mark. Blue and white, their colors, the Notre Dame Victory March is the school song. How'd they get here? Well, they beat Sanborn Central, Woonsocket, and Parkston in Region 5A action, and then a win over Florence Henry in a great ball game down at Madison High School in that SODAC 16, earning them a first-round matchup with the Chargers of Sioux Falls Christian. Let's meet them. Oh, let's take a look at our starting lineups first. There is a look at Hanson's starting lineups. The 5'6 junior, Cadence Jarding. Tasia Hawkins, the 5'7 sophomore, by the way, the granddaughter of Jim Bridge, the head coach. Alyssa Moschelle, 5'9 senior. Eliza Oltmans, the 5'9 senior. And Kylie Heyer, a 5'9 junior. So, again, a relatively young team in Hanson. They've got 3 seniors, 4 juniors, 4 sophomores, and a freshman on the roster. Take a look at the number 2 seed here in this tournament. Even younger when we get to that, we'll talk about it. The Chargers is out of Minnehaha County in the state's biggest city of Sioux Falls. Dan DeYoung, the head coach, they're up near the top of that Class A enrollment at 300. Royal blue, silver, and white. And there was a school song, 17-2. They beat Baltic and West Central. And then a win over Miller. Handily, 62-22 in that SODAC 16. They will start like this. Aubrey Van Beek, the 5'7 sophomore. Katie Vanderlees, the 5'8 junior. Jackson Swift, a 5'9 senior. Avery Wright's a 5'9 junior. And Maya Nelson, a 5'6" junior. And they won the state title in volleyball. Those weren't names that you heard. That's the crazy thing. They've got some unbelievable athletes down here at Sioux Falls Christian right now.
Right, and can you imagine if they all came together?
Maybe they wouldn't be as good at each if they did that. I don't know. But they're pretty talented for sure. Actually, their volleyball team's bigger than their basketball team, which is interesting.
Yeah.
So we will talk a little bit about that as we go. We've got a couple of specials, hopefully to be able to find time at halftime to run a quick little thing that we did with Jim Bridge. Actually, I had a chance to visit with him yesterday about becoming the winningest all-time head coach in basketball history in South Dakota. And it's pretty cool. We've got 4 different cuts. We'll play those throughout the weekend. And then we're going to put together a big show for social media coming up as the tournament wraps up and we get into next week. We get ready for our starting lineups. We'll have our national anthem coming up as well. We turn it over to our public address announcer, Mr. Al Bahi.
Good evening, basketball fans. Welcome to Brookings. Welcome inside the Dakota Bank Center. the South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, Dakota Bank, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, ABC Rentals, Lake Area Tech, and the South Dakota Army National Guard welcome you to this quarterfinal session of the State A Girls High School Basketball Tournament. Our first game this evening will feature the visiting team on the scoreboard from Hanson High School, taking on the home team on the scoreboard from Sioux Falls Christian High School. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of our high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you will enjoy the games and support these athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, will you please stand as we honor America? Tonight, we are proud to present the Teospazina Drum Group and their advisor, Michael Peters, to perform the Lakota Flag Song. The Flag Song is a musical composition dedicated to honoring the American flag. Following the completion of the Lakota Flag Song, please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem. The members of the Teospazina Drum Group are advisor Michael Peters, Tawawani Peters, Devon Bluehorse, Eric Jens Jr., and Kenneth Johnson Jr. Again, we ask that you please remain standing. Tonight, the national anthem will be played by the McCook Central Pep Band from McCook Central High School. Let's meet the cheer teams from each high school. First, for the visitors from Hanson High School, cheer coaches are Tommy Kuzer and Paige Weisler. Cheerleaders are Stephanie Allner. J.C. Heason, Jaden Hofer, Jocelyn Tegadoff. Cheer team from Sioux Falls Christian High School. Cheer coach, Misty DeGroot. Cheerleaders are Izzy Boltzma, Olivia Haugen, Claudia Heatheis, Libby Jensen, J.C. Schlenker, Anna Shimon. Tonight we will introduce the starting lineups in alternating fashion, first starting with the visiting team from Hanson. Starting at a guard, a 5'6 junior, number 5, Cadence Jarding. From Sioux Falls Christian, a 5'7 sophomore, number 1, Aubrey Van Beek. For Hanson, a 5'9 senior, number 12, Eliza Oltmans. For Sioux Falls Christian, a 5'8 junior, number 4, Katie Vanderlees. For Hanson, a 5'9 senior, number 20, Alyssa Moschel. For Sioux Falls Christian, a 5'9 senior, number 5, Jackson Swift. For Hanson, a 5'7 sophomore, number 22, Tasia Hawkins. Starting for Sioux Falls Christian, a 5'9 junior, number 11, Avery Wright. For Hanson, a 5'9 junior, number 24, Kylie Heyer. And for Sioux Falls Christian, a 5'6 junior, number 20, Maya Nelson. Assistant coaches for Hanson, Kim DeRushi and Tyler Pyer. Assistant coaches for Sioux Falls Christian, Zach Perry, Ryan Fetters, and Dana Snyder. Head coach for Hanson High School is James Bridge. Head coach for Sioux Falls Christian is Dan DeYoung. The officials for tonight's contest, referee Corey Edson. Umpire Patrick Deutsch Jr., umpire Shane Bartles, and the alternate official tonight is Pete Entringer.
And here we go. We are ready for our opening game of night number one, halfway through the opening day of the 2024 Class A Girls State Basketball Tournament. I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Lisa Bahia. And here we go, Lisa. We're ready to go. A couple more good ones tonight. Tip it up for Hanson to be number 24, Kylie Heyer. And for Sioux Falls Christian, it'll be Avery Wright, and the Chargers will control. That'll be Maya Nelson giving a handoff out top to Swift. They'll run the weave to get it started. Wright will throw it out top. Swift swing it around. Aubrey Van Beek down the left side. Blocked and then saved on the block by Kylie Heyer. Those are good block shots. Block them and get them back. Down the lane, quickly the other way, too strong with the left hand. That was number 12, Eliza Oltman's, a little quick to the basket that time. Great job of recognizing the open lane.
Yeah, it opened right up for her. Able to get to the hoop, but like you said, just a little bit too strong.
Good defense, Hawkins stepping in there. There's that secondary defender that made it tough on the shot. Hawkins will bring the Beaverettes set. Swing it right side, Jarding. Handoff, higher out there, giving it back to Jarding. Now Hawkins. Last touch by Sioux Falls Christian. 15 on the shot clock. We're 1 minute into this opening game of night number one. Again, our 2 versus our 7. Sioux Falls Christian, your number 2 seed. Hanson, your number 7 seed in this year's state tournament. Block shot, Moschel tried to go up and over the defender. It was partially blocked. Quickly the other way, Jackson Swift, leave it on the run. Good effort. Tell you what, your Brookings Bobcat eighth graders are just in the line of fire on every play down there right now.
They are. Hopefully they're down there taking some notes.
I like how they stood in though. They didn't back away. They sat right in there like, come get me.
Well, there's some tough cookies.
Turnover, last touch, no, by Sioux Falls Christian. So it'll be Hanson basketball. A little full court pressure applied by the Chargers there just to try to force things a little bit. Jardine will bring it up here now for Hanson. Get the Beaverettes set. Man-to-man pressure applied by Sioux Falls Christian. Hawkins on the left side, swing it around. Moschelle to the baseline. Looking for a cutter, gets one. Altman's down the lane, up no good. Eliza just couldn't get that to go. Another extra shot in there for Moschelle, can't get it to go. So the shooting woes continue here early on. We were talking about this at supper. You know, obviously big place and all that. The rims probably aren't real forgiving either, because it's not like there's guys in here dunking on it to loosen them up.
Right, you know, hoops don't get brought out probably quite as often as they would maybe like.
And I don't know where they bring these in, if they're their own or they brought them in special for the tournament, but last touch by Sioux Falls Christian out of bounds. Looks like blackout night for the Hanson student section. Hawkins, a little hesitation dribble. Out top will be Jardine. From the right wing, off the front iron, no good. We are 2 minutes and 15 in, and we don't have a score. Now we do, with the left hand, Alyssa Moschelle. First basket of the game.
A little up and under, and is able to get through to the hoop.
And all of a sudden, Vanderlees goes the other way with one. Break the seal on one end, you make them on the other too, I guess. Here comes Hawkins, the push. Quickly, the good bounce pass across the lane.
Great pass.
Alyssa Moschelle saw Kylie Hires coming across the lane, had an easy look, and then the defense comes over and fouls her.
Moschelle had a pretty good look at the basket also.
Foul goes on Maya Nelson, the 5'6 junior. No good on the first free throw for Hire. Hire will have a second on the way, and in and out and back in. 3-2. Just about 3 minutes in to our first quarter. Nelson brings the Chargers set, fires it back door. Good save down under there by Vanderleest. Nelson will get it back on top. Short enough, coach. Avery Wright's with the triple. Hawkins has it go through the hands, gets it back. Now they got numbers. Good lead, but then taken away. And an easy run out for Sioux Falls Christian. The layup is up and good for Avery Wrights.
Great job of looking down the court. So had a couple players that didn't get back quite in time.
Hawkins for three, got it. Tasia Hawkins, the sophomore sharpshooter from way out on the right wing.
That was from downtown. Hawkins' mother, Jenny Bridge, shot almost 50% from the three-point line in high school.
She was a player, man. She could shoot it. She was a bulldog, too.
Yep.
Story about that, we'll talk a little later. Jim talked about coaching her and coaching his granddaughter and how he had to treat them both differently. And it's a pretty interesting story. Here comes Hanson on the run back the other way after the three-point air ball. Swing it around. Higher, back up top, Jardine. Jardine now off the dribble. Leave it to Hawkins on the right baseline. Thought about it again, skips it. Moschelle off the dribble, down the lane, off the glass, no good, in and out. And there's the unkind rim. Wrights the other way, up and three-point play is good. Or the basket is good, a chance for a three-point play. We'll go to our media timeout. With our score, 9-6. Sioux Falls Christian up three. They'll be back at the free throw line. We'll take a break. Back with more on SDPB.
We hope you're a fan of stories about heroes, because we'd like you to meet a few of ours. These folks keep our communities moving forward. They're dedicated to being here for you, navigating change, keeping you secure, and offering a helping hand to those who need it. Heroes come from many walks. Ours are here to walk with you. Go with trust. Go with people. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out as I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
From the Dakota Bank Center in Brookings, I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Lisa Bahi. It's Class A girls basketball state tournament action. 9-6 our score as that last foul called on Alyssa Moschel and a three-point play opportunity for Avery Wrights. Avery's got 7 in the game right now, 7 of the 9 for Sioux Falls Christian. And the free throw is up and good. Avery is a second team all-conference player. Think about that. They got 2 players on the second team all-conference, and they're in the state tournament. How good is that conference?
Right.
Altman's kick out to the lane. Moschel cross the lane, up and off the glass, and good. Alyssa Moschel with 4 points. Sioux Falls Christian now as we approach the 3-minute mark. We'll come set into the front court. Out top, Wrights again, one-on-one. The give to Vanderlees, who gives it up. Now baseline with 10 on the shot clock. And the takeaway. Hawkins gets that loose ball. Tasia will bring Hanson set. Leave it on the bounce. Step through, nice move, just left it short. Kylie Heyer had a shot. Rugby scrum out there for no ball.
Yeah, I wasn't sure what happened there. I was looking down the court and all of a sudden I saw 2 bodies on the floor.
3 chances for Sioux Falls Christian, and Avery Wrights ends up getting fouled and we'll get 2 free throws out of it. There you see a battle for the rebound. There's Wrights back up and on the elbow, good call as Altman's is guilty of the foul. And Wrights will make good on the first. Subs into the game for Sioux Falls Christian. One of them anyway. Nelson comes back in.
Wrights is a 75% free throw shooter for Sioux Falls Christian.
And that one's no good. So right now she's a 66% free throw shooter. Just a little quick math.
Good job.
Yeah, thanks. My wife, the math teacher, will be proud. 3-pointer on the way, Maya Nelson. And a timeout, Coach Bridge, as the score goes 14-8. Going to try to figure out how to guard that 3-point line. Here you see the kick out, and Nelson, good pass. Hawkins never recovered, or whoever's supposed to come back up there, either.
It looks like Hawkins went down to kind of trap in the corner.
Yeah.
Whether she was supposed to rotate up or someone else was, they didn't get to the spot and she was left wide open.
Communication, got to talk. If you're going to make that switch, got to tell the other player so they know to go up there, right?
Yep. We talk to, as you probably do too all the time, getting girls to talk on the floor. The more you can talk, the more successful you'll be.
As soon as the buzzer goes in the hallway, they don't stop talking.
Exactly.
When they're out there in between the lines, you know, then it's like, come on, come on. But you watch in this tournament, I've kind of keep note of that. That's why they're here, because they're the best 8 teams in the state. They do, for the most part, communicate. You see them talking to each other constantly.
Right.
Altman's on the push. Jarding, good drive, leaves it under the basket. Saved, no, dribbled out of bounds. Sioux Falls Christian student section all saw that. So did the officials. More subs back in for the first time. Avery Moschel, a 5'9 senior. So Alyssa and Avery, twins.
Yeah.
If not twins, they sure look alike.
They are twins. I think they have 2 sets of twins. They have a couple freshman twins.
3 on the way by Jackson Swift is good. And a flurry to finish this first quarter for Sioux Falls Christian. This has been the best quarter of the tournament offensively for any team. Hawkins going to be tripped up. They'll say moving is the defender number five, Jackson Swift.
Might be a silly replay of that.
Oh, left just arm kind of, in there, yeah.
Yep. Close. Right idea.
Oh, yeah, I wasn't sure if they were calling body, but now you see on that shot or on that view, boy, you should really have the arm. Tasia Hawkins with a free throw. She's got 4 points.
84% shooter on the year. That's pretty good for high school basketball.
And I know her mom and uncle, they both were, I think they both shot in like the national free throw contest.
Correct.
Out in Massachusetts.
Correct.
They, that they lived in the gym shooting free throws. In our interview, Jim said, if I had a nickel for every free throw I've rebounded in my life, I wouldn't be here right now. He said, I'd be retired a long time ago.
That's something you see a lot of times. Small town, dad's coach or in the school district, and you have that key to the gym, which is huge.
Just that one little extra perk that you get. On the move, Hawkins will slow it up now. Chance to cut this back to five or four if a knock down a three. Jarding just about had that taken away. Kick out. Hawkins, she'll let her fly from 23. Short, no good, and that'll bounce out of bounds. Nobody touches it. 48 seconds remain in the quarter. Subs back in. Vanderleest and Wrights for Sioux Falls Christian. Back in is Kylie Heyer for Hanson. Sioux Falls Christian going to probably be a little more methodical on this one unless they get an open look right away. Dribble drive out top for Swift. Wrights just about got tripped up. Three on the way for Wrights off the front rim. Oh. No good. Rebound just taken away by Katie Vanderleest.
Nice put back. Then they throw the press on.
Now it's 2-on-1. Good job by Hanson. They elect to back it out. 10 on the clock. 19-10 our score. Hawkins gives it to Jarding. Back to Hawkins. 3-2. Hawkins will let it fly. No good. And we'll go to our first break. 19-10. A big first quarter for Sioux Falls Christian at the hands of Avery Wrights. We'll take a break. We're back with more on SDPB.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
Seriously?
From inside the Dakota Bank Center, Avery Wrights wearing number 11 right there, the 5'9 junior for Sioux Falls Christian. A 9-point first quarter to help her team to 19 in that first 8 minutes, and that's been the biggest output offensively. She's done it from the three-point line. She's gotten to the basket. Now you've seen her just kind of take over in that first quarter.
Right. You know, Sioux Falls Christian, 7 of 18 for 39% and 3 of 7 from the three-point line. Hanson only shooting 25%.
Foul going to be whistled against number one, Aubrey Van Beek. That'll be her first personal, the 5'7 sophomore. Hanson will trigger it in. A little circle cut on the baseline, kind of a flex cut off that inbound. Step through, pass, good cut, and knocked away. Sioux Falls Christian coming away with it on the run. Up off the glass, too strong, no good. Rebound falling away.
High off the glass.
Just hard work. Van Beek stayed with it. Hawkins now, big numbers, 4-on-2. Good pass, another one across the lane, and then the miss. Great job by Moschel to keep that alive. Alyssa Moschel with her sixth point. The basket counts, and she'll go to the free throw line. Foul's going to be called on number 11, Avery Wright, her first personal. And the free throw is good for Alyssa Moschel. Ryan Nelson to bring it across the timeline. Just two seniors for Sioux Falls Christian, four juniors, five sophomores in on the varsity squad, and then four freshmen. Three-pointer on the way, right wing, no good. Rebound, great block out. Ball bounced, and Hanson was the only one close enough to get it. That's good block out.
They had three people right there.
Yeah. Again, I'm going to have to call Bridge up for some blockout drills, I guess, after this season's over. Jarding on the left wing. Oltman's on the drive, left side to the lane. Up, no good. Tapped around. Oltman's
great
goes
hustle
to get it. And throws it away. Was it touched? No. It'll be Hanson basketball.
That's just hard work. You know, tough shot. Creates a shot for herself, but a tough shot, and then just hustling after that to get the rebound.
Again, you talked about rebounding earlier, and not only defense, but maybe offensive rebounding, more so heart, desire, effort. I mean, all those key words. There's a foul underneath. Three was no good, and a push on Sioux Falls Christian.
Yeah, you know, always talking with young players, you want to get 4, 6, 8 more points a game. You know, get 3 or 4 rebounds, put them back in. It's a pretty easy way. It's get some rebounds and put those buckets in.
It's not rocket science.
No, it's not.
It just isn't. We try sometimes make it too hard. Just work harder and get an extra rebound. You got a chance to score more points.
And, you know, rebounding just hard work.
Yep. Three on the way is good for Oltman's. The harder you work, the luckier you get, right? I don't believe in luck, but obviously the harder you get, you create opportunities for yourself, just like Oltman's did there.
Right.
Hard work on the glass. Now she gets open threes. Back to a five-point game, 21-16. 6-2 run to open up the second quarter. Top of the key, Oltman's again, jump stop. Ooh, just about picked that other foot up. And then taken away on top by Van Beek, who has two personals. Oh, correction, that was Vanderlees that took that away.
That three by Oltman's, is that her first basket of the game?
Yeah, yep, her first bucket. She's got three in the game.
Trying to look at the stats up on the board, but the Hanson graphic in the background makes it a little tough.
You know what that says about our eyes, that's all.
That could be too.
You gotta look over those readers.
Exactly.
Wright's down the lane, kick out. Penetrating kick. Now off the dribble. And Sydney Scott, who checked in. Foul called on number 22, Tasia Hawkins. Her first personal, just the second team foul in a quarter and almost 3 minutes for Hanson. That's another reason you can get to a state tournament. You stay out of foul trouble. Don't put the other team at the free throw line. No good on both free throws, though, or free throw attempts for Emery Lems. Oltman's out top, guarded by Lems. Jarding, one-on-one. They'll switch screens and get back. Three on the way for Hawkins, too short. Good hustle, Sioux Falls Christian. Another loose ball. Pass knocked down. Plenty of time on the shot clock and a travel out top.
Sometimes those quick feet get you in a little bit of trouble.
We're going to go to our media timeout at the first timeout, our first dead under five. We're at 4:49 to play in the second quarter, 21-16. Back with more. You're watching the State A Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB Sports.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great. Like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live, where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
From inside the Dakota Bank Center, give a shout out to our camera girls. There's a shot of the Sioux Falls Christian crowd. Jasmine and Kamari, Case Lynn. I know I'm going to screw this one up. Lourdes? Okay, I got it right then. And a good shout, big shout to Caden helping out from ORR back there in the back room with graphics. Those young ladies on the cameras all the way here from Dupree. And there's a bucket good for Oltmans. Eliza Oltmans on the drive. She'll take it the distance, top of the key, all the way down the lane, up off the glass. Not a lot of contact, but we don't call the flop in high school, right. So maybe that's what that was for.
Yep.
Second foul on Maya Nelson. I watch, you ever go to a high school game and a coach thinks somebody's doing it, the coach's like, come on, there's no call. They don't have that call yet in high school, so.
Not yet.
We don't get that. It'll probably be coming too, but. Oltmans makes good on that free throw. She's got 6 points in the quarter, and it's a 2-point game.
You know, I think the flop was on the survey that came out from the Basketball Coaches Association for rule changes.
Could have been,
if you're in favor of it or not for the high school level.
I'm going to say no. Just, I get it.
Right.
But coaches need to coach their kids up not to do it a little bit better. That would be my side of it. But you put too many things on officials to have to watch for something like that, and it's just too subjective. You know what I mean?
I always told my kids they should probably take art of drama and just work a little bit on the acting part.
That's right.
Can sell it once in a while.
That's going to be a hold. Foul called on number 21, Maya Van Dong. Maya picks up her first personal. That is enough team fouls to put Hanson at the free throw line. And have a little conversation with Coach DeYoung probably over here. Hawkins will go to the free throw line. She's got 5 points. Those all came in the first quarter. At 80%, you said 82?
84%.
84% free throw shooter. You don't expect her to probably miss one for a little while here.
I'm sure between mom and grandpa, they probably get a lot of rebounding at the free throw
line. I would think so. And back in will be Aubrey Van Beek, as Hawkins made good on both. And all of a sudden, we're tied up. It's an 11-2 run in this quarter in the first 4 minutes here for Hanson to tie it up. Trailed 19-10 at the end of the first quarter.
Great full court man-to-man defense by number 5, Candace Jardine.
Down the lane, Swift up and good. Jackson for the first layup, or her second basket, first 2-point field goal.
Did a good job of getting the corner turned on that one.
Yep. That's what you see. You talk to kids about that. Come off the screen or whatever on top. Get headed downhill. And sometimes they widen it out, let the defense get back in.
Yeah, the defense has an opportunity to catch back up to you.
That's going to be a travel. Yeah, you can't penalize the defense on that one. They had the spot moving right where they're supposed to, and little contact happens because the offense draws it. Avery Wright's back in. It's like a carousel of subs going on over here. I'm getting dizzy.
Yeah. It's nice to have a deep bench.
It reminds me of Elf at the office building just going through the door. To the lane, up and too strong. Van Beek, put back no good, and a foul on the rebound going to be called on number 21, Maya Van Dong. That'll be her second personal. Back to the other end to shoot free throws with 3:13 to play. trailing by two, the Beaverettes at the free throw line.
Should have been able to just kind of tip that out of there, probably wouldn't have got called for the foul, but when...
Yeah, you try to go with two hands, it's tougher to do.
Yeah, and Heyer was able to rip that down and kind of pull her over top and almost kind of created the foul.
There was a kind rim for Kylie Heyer. Eight of 10 at the free throw line in this first half are the Beaverettes. So better free throw shooting than we've seen in the two games prior.
And Kylie Heyer, its first cousin, Kaya Schmidt from Mount Vernon Plankinton.
Very cool. So they both get to play in the tournament.
And both of their mothers were Barchers from Hanson.
From Hanson, not Barchers from Ethan.
Right, okay. Right. So
probably related to those Barchers, too. Great
probably.
Putback. Aubrey Van Beek with the putback.
Wonder how many... players Coach Bridge has coached, both their mothers and their daughters.
Yeah, that would be another
good
stat.
That'd be a great question.
He and I talked about just go across South Dakota alone, but Midwest, maybe across the country, who gets a chance to coach their own daughter and their granddaughter?
Right.
That might even be more impressive. I mean, as far as just, it just doesn't happen that often, the longevity. A lot of guys will coach that long, just that maybe families move away and
right.
You don't have them in the same school. And most people don't coach 38 years in the same school anymore. 44 technically, but
yeah. Spent a few years as an assistant in the men's program.
Altman's too strong. Sioux Falls Christian wanted a kick on that last possession down here, and I think if the ball hit the floor first and then rolled up her leg, that's why it's not a kick.
Right.
Yeah, that's just the ref just said to him, I saw it hit the floor and roll up. Sometimes I think I should just put the stripes on. I just don't, sometimes. I'd have to run up and down the floor, though, so I'm probably not going to do that. Every official that ever does my games is saying, well, you try it every time you're coaching anyway. What's the difference?
I find myself stopping and watching too long.
Good rebound again. Oldman's on the block out. Hawkins, right wing, one-on-one. Now she'll back it out. Hesitation dribble to the baseline. Leave it on the bounce. Holtman's, she's just one of those kids always around the loose ball, isn't she?
She's
constantly around the ball.
Yeah, just look at the stats. She only has two rebounds. I thought she had more than that because she's just always where the ball's at.
Yeah.
And has a good knack to finding it. But there's been quite a few times Hanson on the defensive end, what a great job of creating that rebounding cup.
Oltman's too strong. Yeah, you do that drill in practice where you say, all right, nobody can get a defense. You can't get it till it bounces. You got to block out that long. How many times in a game does that ever happen, really? But you do it to try to hold that block out. We've seen it twice already
in this game.
Two misses for Altman's at the free throw line, and it's 25-22. Sioux Falls Christian led by as many as nine in this game at 19-10 at the end of the first. Again, we'll visit with the leading coach at halftime, going down to the locker room, get their take on this first half.
There she is, catching another rebound off the backside.
Michelle will kick it out, Jardine with the travel. A little quick with her feet. Looks like we're going to get a quick 30 by Coach DeYoung with a minute six to play. Try to set something up, get a bucket here. Extend that lead going into halftime if possible. With a minute six to play. Yeah, there's a lot of pretty cool connections in these state tournaments. And, I mean, you always think that, well, the bigger level you go to from Class B to A to AA, you have less connect. But you don't. You find connections all across this great state, up and down the lineups of these schools.
That's right. But when you coach 44 years in the state, you create a lot of those connections too.
I just enjoy the opportunity to obviously be here and call these games, but just to look around during these breaks and see people from across the state sitting here that come to watch these games that really don't have a horse in the race, so to speak. They just want to watch basketball, and they just show up because, oh, there's a state tournament. I got to go watch the state tournament. I mean, I love that. Hanson will come out. man-to-man with 1:06 to play in this first half. Circle cut from the top right away.
Nice. Nice look.
Great pass down inside from Wrights to Lems, and Lems will have a chance for a three-point play. Right now, the way Wrights played in that first quarter, you know, if you're Hanson, you're out trying to make sure you get a hand in her face or, you know, distract her as much as you can. Now she turns into a passer.
Right.
And no good on the free throw. Under 50 seconds to play in the half. 27-22. Oltmans. O'Shell, travel.
A little extra hop there.
Yep. Picked it up and moved that right foot, then hopped into both of them. It's another thing that happens too, postseason, but state tournament especially, all those little things that maybe during the season, not that the referees miss it, but you get away with just for whatever reason. And it tightens up. When you get to the state tournament, it's just going to be called tighter.
Well, and also just sometimes her original move probably was there during the season, but now defenses are a little bit better and they take it away and you have to counter with something.
For sure. Under 8, 7, 6, 5. Shot on the way, no good. Rebound, Oltman's another one. Three-quarter court shot, no good. And we're going to go to halftime, 27-22. We'll catch up with Coach DeYoung from Sioux Falls Christian. We're going to do it right away. He's right here. We'll get over here in front of the camera. And Coach DeYoung, talk real quick. Get you in your locker room. Talk about that first half, things that you saw from your team.
Yeah, I thought we played really hard in that first quarter. We brought the energy, and we really pressured onto it. Then we just got in some foul trouble there. And all of a sudden, that just limited our pressure, kind of limited the flow of the game. Shots didn't go in quite as much.
What did you talk about at halftime coming out with that foul trouble?
Yeah, we just got to continue to play our game. We're a deep team that we can continue to go to that next person. And I think different girls are stepping up for us right now. We just got to continue to be able to play hard, continue to get up into our pressure, and just play smart.
Coach, appreciate the time. Best of luck second half. You bet. Dan DeYoung, the head coach for Sioux Falls Christian. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more, look at some stats, some highlights, and get ready for our second half here in Brookings at Dakota Bank Center, Class A girls basketball on SDPB.
Dreamer, doer, difference maker. These are just a few things we look for when growing our team at Dakota Bank. Those with empathy and a commitment to doing what's right build their careers with us. If you're about relationships and helping others, Dakota Bank is calling. Will you answer? Go with integrity. Go with teamwork. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is as I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
Coverage of the South Dakota High School Activities Association event is made possible by a partnership between the SDHSAA and SDPB. Sponsors of SDPB's coverage include Dakota Bank, South Dakota Corn, and by Lloyd Companies, Bank West, South Dakota State University, the South Dakota Department of Education, and by your membership in the Friends of SDPB.
A Welcome back to halftime at Dakota Bank Center in Brookings. The West Central Drumline is entertaining the crowd. I like it. They got a little music pumping behind them. Popular modern songs, and they're playing the drums, doing their drumline thing to that song. That's pretty good stuff.
It is good stuff. And they got their LED lights on their drums. Shut the lights off, it'd be pretty cool.
I know, they match, and they match the Flandreau cowgirl hats over there.
Yeah.
With all their lights. I was talking to Georgia Adolph from Flandreau, for a longtime coach and teacher over there. And I said, you look pretty blingy. She said, and I get to sit right next to you to do the book later. I'm like, great, that won't be distracting. Let's talk stats real quick from that first half.
All right, we got a Sioux Falls Christian, 27 points on 11 of 31 from the field, 3 of 12 from the three-point line, 21 rebounds. Talked a little bit about a couple people in a little bit of foul trouble. My number 21, Maya D. Van Dung, has three.
Yep.
And
I think right to
Aubrey Van Beek has two, it looks
there you
like.
Go. And Maya Nelson,
and Maya
has,
Nelson
two
has two. Yeah, so you know, being a little cautious, keeping them probably out of the game a little bit, trying not to pick up that third one going into the half. Hanson shooting 6 of 20 for 30%, 2 of 7 from the three-point line, 18 rebounds, with 7 of those going to Alyssa Moschelle and 4 to Oltmans, which she averages about 6.5. I was looking at that because she is kind of has a knack for being around the ball. Points scored, Oltmans, number 20, Alyssa Moschelle, and Hawkins all have 6, 7, and 7 respectively. And for Sioux Falls Christian, I think I left them out, Avery Wrights has 9, and Jackson Swift has 5.
So again, another good first half of basketball. Maybe a little bit better than what we've seen. We'll talk a little bit more about that. We're going to talk with Coach Bridge from Hanson when they come back out. We'll take a break. Back with more here in Brookings on SDPB.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success. Building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Are you nervous?
A little.
And action!
Right things ahead, darling. Brightness and joy.
I've got plans.
Everything feels better after a cup of tea.
No, Falcon.
I just want to be right here in this moment with you.
You're going to be a bigger star than ever.
This is good news for all of us.
Best episode ever.
All right, I think Coach DeBeer is having a little trouble with the mic down there. So one other note of that first half, Hanson did not score the last 4 minutes and 35 seconds of that second quarter.
Yeah, that's a big stat, the way this thing came out. We got the mic back now. I see Coach Bridge making his way out. And that was a great halftime. If the crowd wasn't amped up enough, they certainly will be now. as Coach Bridge makes his way out. We'll grab him and visit a little bit about that first half. Coach, let's talk real quick. A rough first quarter, down 19-10, but boy, you really fought back that second quarter.
Yeah, we just got beat on the boards a bunch there. I mean, it was a little more physical than we probably are used to, and we got to weather that. I mean, we just got to be stronger with the ball, and we got to keep them on our backs. And I like our intensity, I like our effort, but we've just, and then we had some dumb turnovers there in the second quarter that were just not on, they were on us. You know, we got to help ourselves a little bit to that. And so, I don't know, I feel decent. I'd like to be closer, I'd like to be ahead, but, you know, we're right there. I think we just got to not get down on ourselves here.
What do you talk about the kids shooting-wise? I mean, they've had good looks. They've had a couple that have just been on the rim.
Yeah, we didn't finish very good. We had some opportunities in that first quarter where I'd rather be getting those shots and missing them than not getting them and not knowing what to do with it. But we're going to make a couple adjustments, hopefully, in the second half. It's going to help us, you know, get even better looks.
Appreciate the time. Good first half. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thanks a lot, Brad.
You bet. Jim Bridge, the head coach at Hanson. We'll throw it back to a wide shot, and I'll make my way back to the table. We'll get ourselves ready to go here, Lisa, for a second half. And it's funny, you hear Coach Bridge talk about getting physical on the boards, and we thought they really rebounded well.
Right, you know, and it's amazing to me knowing Coach Bridge and how he seems a little calmer the older he's gotten. You know, one thing I think to watch in this second half, Hanson's only played six kids. They have three that played that and didn't come off the floor. Where Sioux Falls Christian's played nine kids, and most of them, they have, what, three that played 13. So, you know, the timeouts help, mm-hmm. The media timeouts do help with that, but just something to see going into that game.
Yeah, in the end, how's that wear down if you're down and you got to play full court kind of thing? There you see some of the highlights back and forth, these two teams. And there's an offensive put back that Coach Bridge was talking about early. He didn't like that his team was not ready for that physicality. But he said something they talked about, obviously, and they'll come out ready to go. You know that, obviously, his team is going to be prepared. I mean,
right,
the guy's
right.
Seen everything you can possibly see. We talked about that in an interview that we did yesterday with him about over the years how things have changed. And he says, you know, obviously the athleticism of the kids and that kind of stuff. But he said, the game's still the game, and you got to do those things. Basketball's only, we all steal everything from each other. Everybody
right.
knows
oh,
what's
yeah.
going on.
Oh, exactly, you know, and sitting here watching, you're like, oh yeah, that's what we run that play.
Yeah.
You might call it something different, same
right.
play.
Yep.
So you see a lot of those things, and it comes down just to those fundamental skills.
Well, that's what, like he said, you got to come out, you got to continue to work hard, and you got to do the little things right. You finish baskets under your bat. I mean, in the end, you play defense as hard as you can. If you don't score buckets, you don't win games.
Right.
You know, so.
And, you know, interesting, you're talking about the rims not being maybe as loose as you'd like, something I never thought of, because typically you play in an arena that there's been a lot of basketball being played in.
Yep. Whether it's just the ball bouncing off it a lot or boys are in there dunking and doing their thing. I mean, that loosens up
right.
a rim. It makes a difference for a shooter. So we get ready to
exactly.
go here in our second half. Sioux Falls Christian controls. We'll get the offense started. See what Coach DeYoung made for adjustments in his locker room. Nelson pull up three. No good. That's the thing you can't, and obviously the coaches don't talk to their kids about this, I'm sure, like the way you shoot in here. They just go shoot, just a game. Still 15 feet high, or it's 10 feet high, the basket, or the free throw line's 15 feet away. The three-point line's 19-9. It's all
right.
the same. But again, that's why you shoot so much in the summer and the offseason. Muscle memory, right?
Yep.
Up and good on the fast break points for Maya Nelson. Here comes that full court pressure. And like you said, we'll see if this wears on Hanson as this second half goes on. If you're not in shape by now at 16 and 17, you probably aren't, but you still get tired and you
right,
wear down.
Yep.
There's Oltman's exerting herself a little bit. Oltman's got eight in the game now.
Eight
come the other way with
Vanderlust.
Yeah. See what Avery Wrights does again. She did not score in that second quarter, had nine to open up the game in that first quarter. But only 8 points in the whole second quarter for Sioux Falls Christian anyway, so it was just kind of a rough quarter offensively for them. Here comes Jardine with the push now, off and running the Beaverettes. Hawkins spots up, blocked. Last touched by Sioux Falls Christian. Coach Bridge wanted a foul, but we'll see. Here's a good look at it on the replay.
think Van Beek just got a, maybe a little bit. But
ball into hand, maybe. Yeah. Maybe got ball first, so yeah. They let it go. Again, in that moment, flying by, like, that's a tough call. It's tough to see that anyway. Takeaway on the baseline. Maya Nelson running out again. Left hand no good, and there's a foul. The body underneath going to be called on Kelly Heyer. Heyer will pick up her first personal. Here you see the run out. Good pass. Diagonal ahead of the group. Let your offensive player go to the hoop.
The way the first almost 2 minutes have gone, you think that Sioux Falls Christian probably talked a little bit about really trying to push the ball down the court.
They've run every trip so far, yeah. Except for the first one when they took it out at half court.
Really looking to push the tempo.
Nelson makes good. Both free throws for Nelson. She's got all 4 points in this second half. It's 31-24. Back to a 7-point lead. And another steal and a run out. And Hawkins got her hand in on the ball and then just took the player to the floor, but again, made an attempt at the ball.
I got knee in the quad there.
That's exactly what happened. Yeah.
Yeah, trying to walk that off a little bit.
Hawkins' left knee into the right quad of Aubrey Van Beek. Hawkins picked up her second personal. And Van Beek makes good on that one. 5 points in the game. Chance to go back to a 9-point lead. Would tie the biggest lead of the game yet for either team. Sioux Falls Christian held that at 19-10. Sub coming in will be
Scott.
Yeah, Sydney Scott, the 5'5 sophomore, in for Aubrey Van Beek, the 5'7 sophomore. Napers, another takeaway. The defensive intensity has just amped up for Sioux Falls Christian. And now another rebound and a run out. No, they'll slow it down. They want to travel. That was a good jump stop just to let everybody clear.
Yeah, good decision because yeah. The last couple times seemed like they'd got that picked away.
Hanson now up top. That defensive pressure for Sioux Falls Christian has changed this game right now in this third quarter.
Yeah, they're really getting after him, pushing them outside the three-point line.
Hawkins too deep, nowhere to go with it.
Yeah, Wright's long arms got a piece of that one.
Coach DeYoung screaming every time, go, go. Nelson on the run will throw one in.
Nice little running kind of hook.
Another trap. This time they'll trap the sophomore in a timeout. Coach Bridge has seen enough. He didn't want another turnover down 11. 30-second timeout just to save that possession. Going to try to set up there. Press breaker just a little bit better and get that. It's funny because a lot of press break or a lot of full court traps, full court press, you force them to a corner. They're trapping everywhere. They don't care where
right
they're
in the middle
at.
Of the court.
It's the minute they touch it, they're going.
Yep.
On one dribble, get the ball stopped and just attack it. It's the difference in the girls' game and the guys' game, I think, in high school. You can get that trap. You don't see a lot of girls' teams step through that trap and split it like you should. Guys, you see that split just, I don't know if it's more natural move or what it is, but it just gets split easier, the physicality of it maybe. Sioux Falls Christian comes right back out, tight 2-2-1, full court.
Interesting at the end of the third quarter, look at the stats. At halftime, we had zero fast break points for both teams.
Yeah, I would say, what, of the eight they've scored here, the six of them?
Yeah, probably.
Of course,
yeah.
You got a couple free throws.
A couple free throws in there, yeah.
That was off a fast break, so. This trap or this press, almost a situation where Hanson, there's a 10-second call, where Hanson needs to go sideline to break it. With that, we'll go media timeout. 4:53 to play, 35-24, an 11-point lead. We'll be back with more on SDPB.
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour, you know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing, menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal.
All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
We're all going somewhere. Going higher, faster, farther. Going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Class A girls basketball state tournament action. There's the nice wide shot of Dakota Bank Center. Great crowds on hand here thus far. The place holds 3,700, so obviously we aren't sold out, but the lower bowl, if you will, that's been pretty full for all three games.
You know, and looking at, I think a lot of girls probably hoping to play up at Frost Arena. That's about what Frost Arena holds, so you're not out a lot of seats.
And Watertown is about the same. I think it actually is a little less when you really take a look at it, but regardless, it's worked out. A lot of people would like to come to Brookings and play at Frost Arena, I'm sure.
Right, yeah.
It's going to be under construction now and become First Bank Arena, First Bank and Trust Arena. The foul after the rebound.
You know, that last possession right before the media timeout. Hanson, if they could have just got the press broke, Sioux Falls Christian had four people trapping up in the front court. If they would have had a nice 3-on-1 look, if they can just get the press broke a few times, it'd help open things up for them.
Well, that's the thing. That's what I was about to say, too. It's a press breaker situation, I think, because of how they trap in the middle. And a long three by Hawkins. That'll help. If you can break the press sidelines, if you've got a sideline press break, because a lot of people try to get the ball middle of the floor to break the press. And that usually works. But the way they trap, you almost have to beat them up the sideline quick to get a couple quick passes and go.
Yeah, that or look over, if they could just see over top. And I don't know if they can see over top.
Nope.
You got open people down the court.
And we used to run one called Eagle, sideline Eagle is what we called it for whatever reason. And it just, you run against teams, you try to throw that in there. Long three on the way, no good for Sioux Falls Christian. Not out of bounds. Hit the front of the top of the backboard, but it was on the inside. Good
Nice pass.
Altman's got loose behind everybody, and a great look from Cadence Jardine.
That was a beautiful pass, and we probably are sitting in the perfect angle to see that.
A lot of kids won't throw that because she wasn't open at the moment, but she threw her open to the basket, and that was great.
Yeah, she would have waited. That pass wouldn't have been there.
Yep. Offensive. We're going to have a moving screen maybe over on the other side. Yep. Foul going to be called against number 12, Sydney Scott, her second personal. Line change coming in here for all you hockey fans. State hockey tournament next door starts tomorrow, right?
Yeah, it does. It's going to be a busy side of town.
I better put my sign out so I get my parking spot out back tomorrow.
I think they're...
Did we get parking spot signs? We should probably put those out there with the state hockey tomorrow, right? 3:21 to play. Thank you, Christian. There you go. Here comes another look at the press breaker. 4-on-3, and then a foul going to be called. Probably a good foul on number 15, Neely Stanford, who's come in to play some defense.
Well, you saw Sioux Falls Christian come out of the half, really trying to force the game, and Hanson kind of doing the same to start the second half of this quarter, really pushing the ball themselves, trying to not get trapped to break that press.
Yeah, what was 11-point lead, now back to 6. You almost see, we talked about this in the last game, an offense for defense type thing. That's what they're doing with Nelson and protecting a couple of those girls that had in foul trouble this whole third quarter. They brought 2-3 people on a couple of defensive trips, and boom, they sub as soon as they get a dead ball.
Hanson back within 4, putting on a little press of their own.
Good job by Sioux Falls Christian. You know the old adage, press a pressing team. Sometimes they're not real good at breaking it, but Sioux Falls Christian did a good job. Good score by Van Beek down inside. Don't look away from this one. You're going to miss something. There's a lot of action right now. Foul going to be called on number 15, Neely Stanford again.
Neely Stanford, only a freshman.
She didn't like it, but that was, in the big city, you spend a little night in jail for that kind of a an attack. There's a good look. Oh, threw it down the sideline out of bounds. Right idea, just threw it wide. 37-31, 2:29 to play in the quarter. More subs back in. Number 21, Avery Moschel will come in for Kylie Heyer. Hawkins comes up to play a little full court. Hanson in there man-to-man. Nelson goes right wing to Van Beek. Wright's down the right side, back to Van Beek. Left-hand drive, and they're gonna call offensive foul on number one, Aubrey Van Beek. Player control foul, here you'll see it. Good ball movement, and then lowers the shoulder right at the end, maybe.
She was going to the basket hard.
Yep. Tough call simply because they're both doing what they're supposed to. Sometimes that's a good no call. You get yelled at more for that, but another takeaway. And back up by Vanderleest. Missed the first one, stayed with it. Now we got fast break for Hanson. Hawkins had players, couldn't get him the ball. Jarding, good hesitation.
Good
long
out.
Two, no good. Coach DeYoung says go. Maya Nelson and a foul on Hawkins. Hawkins thought she had all ball. The officials think differently. We'll have a good look at it. Be right in front of you here.
She might have hit all ball with that left hand, but I think the right hand's what got her in trouble.
Yeah, and arm to arm, it's still a foul. Just because it's your elbow that hits the other girl, it's still a foul.
Right.
Like, you know, I didn't hit her, my hand was on the ball. You're right, but your elbow hit her. I can't do that. As Nelson makes good on that free throw. Don't get me wrong, if I'm Tasia and she's my player, I'm begging that that's not a foul, too.
Yeah,
I would agree
with
her, but sitting here, it's a lot easier to be, you know, impartial. So.
Well, replay's a little slower.
Yeah. And Nelson makes a couple of free throws, comes back out on defense. Back in comes number 10, Emery Lems. Take out 5'6", bring in 6 foot to put some length on that trap up top. Holtmans spins right back into that trap and then throws it away. Look out, bodies everywhere. On the run, Sioux Falls Christian, and they'll throw it out of bounds. Got a little too fast. You love it when your kids are playing so hard on defense. Play fast, fast, fast. Then you got to slow down when you get on the offensive end with the basketball.
Van Beek back in. I think came in for Maya Vendong.
Yeah, that's who checked out.
Hey, you look at this press and Sioux Falls Christian, their fifth player is at the half court line.
Yeah. I don't know if any of these kids play softball or anything, but now's when you want to send someone deep, get an easy one over the top. You got Altman's right here.
Yeah, they're making a little adjustment.
Try to bring someone to the middle. Now they look to attack sideline. That's exactly what you do to get it across half court. Just don't pick it up.
Sioux Falls Christian does a great job retreating, though, out of that, even though they have four people far up on the press. Hanson's got the ball down the court a couple times that didn't get really good looks out of it.
It's interesting how different coaches have different ideas of what they want to do in a trap. A lot of times you press to get steals at the other end at half court, come back where you think somebody shouldn't have the ball. These guys are all about, let's get it before the free throw line on the far end, and if we don't get it, now we'll just get back.
Right.
Hawkins not going to get this one off. Shot clock violation in a 10-point game. Seconds to play in the third quarter. Boy, if you're Sioux Falls Christian, you can be a little patient now and then find the shot you want. If you're Hanson, you want to get a stop and a bucket to get it under double digits going into that final 8 minutes. Wrights up off the glass and no good. Avery's got 9 points in the game and they all came in the first quarter.
About a half second to a second difference in the shot clock to the game clock.
Moschel way out high. She's gonna give it up. Jarding will swing it. Back to Jardine. Three on the way. Too strong. Good rebound. Board. Higher to Altman's on the baseline. Little eight-footer in and out. No good. And a foul going to be called on number one, Aubrey Van Beek. I think she hit her in the head. Mr. Deitch says, doink, doink.
Got Maya Nelson set to come back in on offense.
Yep.
Like you talked about, really doing a good job again, the offensive, defensive substitutions.
And again, she's kind of that catalyst on offense. That she's got the ball in her hands. She gets him in everything. So you save her having to put out extra energy, too. It's kind of a nice luxury to have with all those extra players. Most teams can't play 9-10 kids and not lose anything. So
right.
Holtman's misses on that first. She got 10 points in the game. Now she's got 11, and it's a 9-point game. Got it under double digits. Can they get a stop here in the last 9 seconds? Nelson. Swing it. Get it back. Long three straight on. No. After three quarters of play, 41-32. It's a 14-10 quarter. We'll take a break. Back with our final 8 minutes coming up on SDPB.
Lucky for us, life is full of choices, big and small, just as it should be. They define us, make us who we are. And when it comes time for you to choose, a car, home, your next big adventure, or start a new business, Farmers Union Insurance has the variety of choices to make sure you have the perfect coverage to protect each perfect moment. Farmers Union Insurance.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
There's a look at the Hanson student section, chewing fingernails. They're a little nervous about going into this last 8 minutes. You got some scores from those other two tournaments. What do you got?
Yeah, Harrisburg up on number two seed Mitchell, 38-31, end of the third period. And on the B side, we haven't quite started that game. Should be...
No score update anyway. Yeah. I think they're underway, but probably just no score update.
Right.
So. Again, we are just under 8 minutes away from putting our third team into the semifinals tomorrow night. Right now, Sioux Falls Christian with a 9-point lead. Jardine,
nice
good
cut.
Find. Yeah, Moschel with a great cut.
Had an overload on that side, and she was able to kind of find a spot to slip right in there.
Oh, wide open underneath. Good job by Avery Wright to find Emery Lenz all alone under the hoop. Michelle will bring it across. Then attack the lane. Oh. Good pass. Left it a little behind her.
Yep. Tried to pass that one hand. Shuffle pass. Bounce pass.
Throw it where she's going to be, not where she's at.
Yeah, we talk about that a lot.
To the baseline. Hanson does look a little tired right now on defense, just kind of standing straight up and down.
Well, and just, you know, facing a press the whole night takes its toll a little bit too.
Hawkins had to just kind of step away. She doesn't want to pick up that fourth and was blessed to have that layup missed. Teammate grabs the rebound. Jardine now. Kick out. Altman's three on the way. No. Sioux Falls Christian with another run out. Good block from behind, but Wrights is there. Four Sioux Falls Christian girls under the basket to get a fast break rebound. Heyer gets a nice screen down on the bottom. Now Sioux Falls Christian will run again. The luxury of fresh bodies constantly.
Yeah. We got a line next dead. We got a line, another line change coming up for Sioux Falls Christian.
Now Altman's will get a run out. Two on one. She'll keep it and up and good. They're going to call that because she fell early.
Yep.
Tried to get that contact and falling down.
I think she might know that a little bit too. That makes three for Maya Nelson.
At least she grunted loud. They got grunt louder to get that call.
So we got Van Beek with four personal fouls and Nelson with three for Sioux Falls Christian.
Along with Maya Van Dong off the bench with three. And Altman's makes that free throw. 14 on the game for Altman's.
A little bit above her average, 12.4.
Yeah.
Almost drug that left back foot.
Van Beek, 10 points in the game. Another takeaway. Gotta rip that ball away. There's so many violent held balls in girls basketball. Boys, they'll call that one right now. The minute they're both on it, it's a jump. Girls, they fight a little bit, and then somebody gets thrown to the floor, and then the crowd screams at them. Or, that's just rough play. Way out high, Aubrey Van Beek. Lems now. Spin move. Van Beek will swing at Nelson against Hawkins. Good backdoor cut, and that one thrown over her head. Ran out of real estate down there. It was a good cut. Yep. Had her right away.
Yep.
And then tried to squeeze it in.
Squeeze it in, and just maybe a little too high.
5:02 to play. Next dead ball will be our media timeout, our final media timeout. And we'll leave it up to the coaches to stop things. 10-point game right now. Hawkins step through off the glass.
Nice.
Got it. And we'll go to the media timeout on the Hawkins bucket. And she'll have the free throw opportunity. 47-39. Back with more on SDPB.
It's time to focus on you. A healthier you. It's time to get back to better health. Regular visits with a primary care provider at Sanford Health can lead to better overall health and wellness. It's time to get back to regular care. It's time for a healthier you and better health. It's time to see your doctor at Sanford Health.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
And we're back inside the Dakota Bank Center. We're ready for a free throw. You can become an SDPB member today. First Bank and Trust with support from Van and Barb Fishback, inviting you to support high school sports on SDPB. Your new member donation will be automatically matched, doubling your gift. Take advantage of this match by donating today at sdpb.org. Call 800-777-0789. Or just go right there on the webpage, scan that right now, and then click the donate button, and you're good to go. Pretty cool stuff. Thank you, Van and Barb, First Bank and Trust, right here in Brookings. Tasia Hawkins, 12 points in the game, make it 13. Perfect at the free throw line, 5 of 5, an 84% free throw shooter, and it's a 7-point game. Next 2 minutes, crucial for Hanson. Can you keep this at 7 or under? Where do you get away from you, then it's tougher.
You know, and Hanson pressing a little bit of their own, but you got to know when the girl drops behind you.
Falling away from the hoop that time on a layup attempt. Sydney Scott just got lost where she was. Alternating possession arrow. It was a held ball over there. That was a quick one. I didn't see that.
Well, they might have heard you reference the letting them hang on to it a little too long the time before.
Well, the guy on their TV said, you touch it both at the same time, automatic. So, first time the referees ever listened to me. Are you kidding me? No comments, Brett Buck. I know what you're thinking. Tasia Hawkins on the wing. Down to the baseline. Michelle will swing it back to higher, and then the Beaverettes get it to Oltmans for a three. No, too strong.
Oh, battle
for the rebound. Michelle again. Another turnaround put back on the baseline. Alyssa Michelle. 11 points in the game. It's a five-point game, and a takeaway by Oltmans. A lot of contact. Look out. Coach Bridge, slow down over there, big fella. 62 years old. He's bouncing around like he's 18 again down there. Held ball. We're coming the other way. 47-42. That's great. Basketball brings out the youngster and everybody, doesn't it? Sports in general.
Especially just, March Madness.
Yeah, I mean, it just brings out the young in everyone. He was telling me earlier how, you know, I'm 62. I'm getting so old. Yeah, right. Right wing. Avery Wright. Same it up top now. And Beek will swing it. Nelson. Hanson, all of a sudden, a little boost of energy has cranked up the defense. Down to five on the shot clock. Nelson will fire from long range. Oh. Got it! Huge shot for Maya Nelson.
That is a big basket.
Big in the fact that it was a three alone, but bigger yet because of the time running out. My goodness.
Time running out of the shot clock. Even just the point we're at in the game where Hanson's trying to make that run.
And then stepped out of the baseline going away. 50-42, eight-point game. Rochelle. On the trigger from Hawkins, gives it back to Hawkins. Screen up top, little pick and pop, but couldn't get it to Michelle.
I had a little panic for her for a second. I didn't see Hawkins with the ref in the way.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't know who she was handing it off to.
Hawkins pull up from 17, no good. Rebound, one-hander. Avery Wright just ripped that one out of there. 2.5 minutes to play. Got to think about Hanson probably start using a couple of timeouts if they can get stops and buckets. Yeah. That's the thing. You can get as many stops as you want, but you got to score at the other end to get that timeout. Get that
nice backdoor
momentum
cut
on your side. Boy, Sioux Falls Christian has missed some bunnies
They've
in
had
this
some
quarter,
really
too.
Good looks. Really good looks down the stretch.
8-point lead. Harrisburg up 14 with 2 minutes to play in the game down in Sioux Falls. Number two going to go down in double A.
Number one had a tough battle earlier today, had probably a little bit of a scare going to overtime.
Higher blocked and saved on the baseline by Nelson. Nelson now swing it left side. Van Beek stand around. Hanson tried to catch their breath to dig in for the last minute, 40 to play defense. And that worked. Jordan takes it away.
Sioux Falls Christian just quick to get back.
Oh. And then Hanson a little loose with the basketball, unfocused, if you will.
Probably just trying to go a little too fast.
Yeah.
I can remember Coach Frederick's one of his favorite lines: "Pause for poise."
Yep, that's great. That's a great phrase. And you can only play, you play hard.
Right, right.
But playing fast, you know, John Wooden used to say that, you know, be quick but don't be in a hurry type thing. And that's kind of what we're seeing is the hurry right now.
Right.
And I get it. You're trying to
you're feeling that sense of urgency.
Yep.
The 1:30 left to play. And
Sioux Falls Christian going to use one of their four timeouts remaining as a 60-second timeout. Dandy Young will bring his team in a huddle and kind of get them paused to get poised maybe here for the last 126.
probably thankful it saves their three timeouts that they have and they can get a little break. I'm sure Mitchell Christian probably going to talk about possessions with what we got left, 45 seconds?
Yeah, every possession matters. Now, they always do, but they really do now.
What we got left for time? Because we got the 126. All right, 126. I'm like, I didn't think it was 45 seconds. We got the timeout clock running.
In Play with Craig Maddock features in-depth discussions about all things sports in South Dakota. Through these conversations, we learn about the players, programs, and legends who helped shape the current sports landscape of the Mount Rushmore State. Find the podcast on Apple, Google, Spotify, and wherever you get your podcasts. Be sure to leave us a 5-star review so that others are able to find it. Listen now wherever you get your podcast. In Play with Craig Maddock. Getting some great stuff on there, and it all gets posted to social media eventually, too. You can find it there. Follow along. There's some great stories in this great state of South Dakota.
We've got Harrisburg over Mitchell with 1 minute left, up 50-41.
Okay, so back to 9 all of a sudden. But
and B's end of the first period, Lyman 11 over number 3, Harding County 8.
Harding County undefeated, right,
I believe? Yeah, yep.
So Lyman really good. Former Jackrabbit Cody Vollmer, the head coach there at Lyman. His daughter, Junior, is really good.
If she's like her daughter or dad, she's got some athleticism.
Yeah, there's some length, and she spent some time in the gym, you can tell.
He was one of my favorite SDSU players to watch him dunk.
Yeah, he was just crazy, too, wasn't he? West River Cowboy that could hoop it up.
Well, I can remember going to the opening night at midnight.
Oh, yeah, Midnight Madness.
And he dunked with a cowboy hat on.
I remember that.
Do you remember that one?
I think I was there that night. Hawkins against the press, quickly across half court. Now the attack from Moschel. Down inside block, good defense.
Just got to pull up a little bit sooner and shoot the jump shot.
Yeah. Good decision there, mature decision for Katie Vanderlees, the 5'8 junior. Hanson looks like they're going to kind of back it off and not foul. A 14 seconds difference, shot clock to game clock, but it's a three possession game rather. Long three,
nailed
in the proverbial coffin. Jackson Swift, her 8th point of the game, and that secures it, 53-42. We'll go catch up with Coach DeYoung. Let's take that break right now, and then we'll catch Coach DeYoung on the way out. How's that sound back there, Christian? Back in 2 minutes here on SDPB.
As much as you have accomplished, there are times you'd rather not go it alone. While you determine what direction you go, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with community. Go with neighbors. Go with understanding. Go with support.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
I was looking for something that was gonna be close to home.
Southeast Tech has definitely helped me. I'm actually doing something that I enjoy.
This is the right place to be.
Get your degree, get to work at Southeast Tech.
This is the PBS app. It's ready for you whenever you want full episodes of your favorites, perhaps a little history, or the real story, shows with heart, or the latest news and docs. Even stream your local station live. It's all there waiting for you. So download the PBS app now for everything you love and a whole lot more to explore. Stream anytime, anywhere with the PBS app.
And welcome back inside Dakota Bank Center in Brookings, Class A State Basketball Tournament. Coach DeYoung and Sloan with, he's got his daughter over here. Let's talk a little bit about that third quarter. Boy, you put the press on and you got back to Sioux Falls Christian basketball.
Yeah, that's exactly what you were talking about with getting back to Sioux Falls Christian basketball. That's our identity. We're getting up and down in your shorts. Big thing is we can rotate a lot of different bodies in there, and that's huge. We knew that we were going to be able to break them down eventually and just wear them down, and that's kind of our MO this year.
Talk about the way you push the basketball, but then when you needed to slow down, that maturity, boy, they made some great decisions.
Yeah, we didn't finish as well as we normally do, and we're struggling at making our easy layups that we normally do, and our girls just did a good job of recognizing the situation, realizing when we had to push, when we had to pull it out and be able to extend the time.
To the semifinals tomorrow night. Obviously, everybody's goal, but that feels good.
Yeah, it feels great. You know, we've been here the last couple of years, haven't got out of the first round, so getting here to the next semis is going to be big for us.
Congratulations. Best of luck tomorrow night. I'll let you sit back and watch this one.
Yeah, I'm excited for this game. Be a good one.
Very good. Sloan, are you ready for tomorrow? All right, she's ready. Congrats, Coach. All right, Coach DeYoung and Sloan joining us here as we'll take one more break, and then we'll come back and get you set up and ready. Flandreau and T, the 3 versus the 6, Class A girls basketball in Brookings on SDPB.
Our teams are committed to improving quality of life in our communities. Whether we're planning construction concepts, building a new downtown development, bringing new businesses to our communities, or maintaining your apartment home. We believe everyone deserves a well-built and well-managed place to live and work. This is Lloyd.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
From Brookings, South Dakota, and the Dakota Bank Center, I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Lisa Bahi. It is Class A girls basketball state tournament action. Again, the final score, 53-42, not real indicative again of how that game went, Lisa. 11-point finish, but boy, what a great basketball game.
Yeah, it was a great back and forth basketball game. You know, both teams shooting about 34-35%, so very even. the big difference, Sioux Falls Christian making 20 out of 58 versus Hanson 14 out of 41.
Yeah, they missed some shots. And Coach DeYoung talked about missing some easy shots that they typically make. But I think both teams would say they probably did that. But Sioux Falls Christian made timely shots, a couple buzzer beaters at the shot clock. Made a huge difference. Here you see some of the action from that second half. And there's a big, big three right there late in that game for Sioux Falls Christian to kind of put the nail in the coffin. You got some stats
Well, just the points off turnovers. I thought Sioux Falls Christian was going to have a lot more, but it was 20-16. So quite a few points off the both ways off the turnovers. Also rebounds, lots of rebounds. Hanson 33 and Sioux Falls Christian at 37. So for Hanson, you had three players scoring double figures. You had Oltmans with 14, Alyssa Michelle with 13 and 10 rebounds, and then Hawkins with 13. When you go down to Sioux Falls Christian, Van Beek had 10 points. Avery Wrights had 11 points, and Maya Nelson had 14 to lead them.
Yeah, and again, 36 turnovers between the two teams. That's probably a little uncharacteristic for both of them. But at the same time, they both tried to play a little bit of full court at times, especially Sioux Falls Christian. And Coach DeYoung talked about that big push that they made in the third quarter to get back to their brand of basketball, where they just get up in your face and really make you uncomfortable. And I think we saw them wear Hanson down.
Right, playing nine players, did a great job of transitioning their offensive and defensive players in and out to keep people fresh. Hanson played six players. And
three of them over,
five
four of them over 30 minutes.
One of them, you know, the one off the bench only playing 5 minutes.
Yeah.
So that's just tough when you're going down the stretch, not just physically, but also mentally when you're being pressed the entire game.
Yeah, when you look at the other side of it, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players with 11 and a half minutes or more, so almost 12 minutes or more. Makes a big difference late in the game, that is for sure.
It'll be interesting to see how that affects throughout, you know, sometimes teams will play back-to-back, but to play three games in a row over 3 days is tough.
Yeah, that makes it hard to do for sure. We'll take one more break, and when we come back, we'll get you set and ready for the T Area Titans and the Flandreau Flyers. Stick around, we got a good one coming up, the 3-6 on the way on SDPB.
It's time to focus on you, a healthier you. It's time to get back to better health. Regular visits with a primary care provider at Sanford Health can lead to better overall health and wellness. It's time to get back to regular care. It's time for a healthier you and better health. It's time to see your doctor at Sanford Health.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success. Building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
Established in 1986, the Great Plains Tribal Leaders Health Board represents 18 tribal communities located in South Dakota, North Dakota, Nebraska, and Iowa. Our vision is that all tribal nations, communities, and citizens achieve optimal wellness through the embrace of traditional cultural values and innovative and holistic healing practices, strengthened by tribal sovereignty. For more information on our grant programs, health services, and career opportunities, visit our website at greatplainstribalhealth.org.
The way humans make sense of the world is through stories.
We've got to go ahead and start training to go to Mars.
And lift off.
We pay tribute to all who serve and who have served.
Civilization is precious. Life is precious.
Artists here are making a difference.
I'm trying to seek redemption.
And back at the Class A State Basketball Tournament. Under 5 minutes of warm-ups remain, and we'll get ready for our matchup here between the 3 and the 6. Flandreau will be the home team wearing the white. The T-Area Lady Titans, 19-4. They'll be wearing the navy blue, so you got undefeated Flandreau, 23-0. What a season they've had for Coach Stevenson. Let's talk about Thierry and the Lady Titans first, though. As you take a look at their profile, Lincoln County and T, South Dakota, head coach Adam Shoresman, again, at the upper end of that Class A enrollment at 443. Across the field, the Ohio State theme song or warm-up song will be the school song for them. They beat Beersford. They beat Elk Point Jefferson by 5. That was a big win in that region final. And then a blowout win over Mulbridge Pollock in the SODAC 16 to get to that 16-4 and get here into this state basketball tournament, be the number 6 seed as they get ready to take on the Flyers of Flandreau. So, again, we take a look at the one name, Katie Fasica, number 23, 6'1 senior, future Jackrabbit, playing in the town that she'll be coming to next year. A little bit different color blue, but with the yellow to go with it.
That's right. You know, and looking at, you know, T-Area 19-4, you know, 6 seed, but looking at their season, who they played, they knowing that they're transitioning to AA next year, played 8 AA schools this year and went 6-2. So,
yeah, that's pretty impressive.
Playing some really good talent. You're beating a Harrisburg team that won or just beat the number 2 Mitchell seed in the AAs.
Lost to what? Just Jefferson and O'Gorman, right?
Yeah, yep.
Yeah, pretty impressive. Take a look at Flandreau and the Flyers. Their profile out of Moody County. Moody County seat, actually, there in Flandreau. Megan Sievertson, 171 is the enrollment. Purple and gold, original, the school song.
And another.
Not familiar with that one.
Connection to Hanson, Megan Doyle playing for Coach Bridge, yes.
In that tree, if you will. Clarkville Lake and Sioux Valley fell victim to Flandreau in the regions. And then so the SODAC 16 took on a really good Hill City team and kind of ran away from them. We got to play Hill City this year. Very athletic and a big 6'1", 6'2 girl that is going to have some future at the next level. They start with Lily Klein, the 5'11 senior. Hannah Kroll, a 5'11 sophomore. Sadie Ayat, a 5'8 junior. Lizzie Pavlis, a 5'11 senior. And Claire Shepherd, a 6'2 senior. So a little change in lineup. I know they've, at times this year, started the younger Shepherd, Morgan, as well. So between Morgan Shepherd, the 8th grader, and Hannah Kroll, they go back and forth on who they start sometimes. But regardless, you saw that. Must be a beach theme.
Yeah.
Over here for
T-Area.
Yeah, it's T-Area. I'll tell you what, the student sections outside of Makpaialuta have been full.
Right.
Great following of students for all of these games so far.
Yeah, you know, it's great to see the girls get the support from their schools, from their communities. And it's great for these communities to be able to get here and enjoy the atmosphere and kind of create the atmosphere for the players.
Yeah, it was kind of neat driving downtown. I went downtown in between sessions just to grab a bite. And just watching the town is just a buzz. I mean, you know, you bring all these different schools into your community, Brookings community. You're going to benefit from this, from hotels to, you know, anything from hotels to restaurants, even just the shopping downtown. What a great boost for the economy of Brookings as well.
Oh, yeah, you know, and then just to our north, starting tomorrow, hosting the boys' state hockey. So it's going to, the east side of town is going to be a busy place.
Yeah, if you're coming to town, maybe take the bypass and come in on Madary or even out on Western. Don't come in on the east end here. You're going to just run into traffic all day long, so.
Might want to frequent, if you're looking for some food, the western side of the town also.
If you're looking for something new, check that side maybe. That's right. But don't stop coming to town. Come to town to do that. So,
well, you can try your luck over here at, you know, we got what, Whiskey Creek on this side? Applebee's.
Yeah, that's for sure. There's plenty of stuff in town right now to eat. So as we wind things down, we'll get ready for the 3-6 matchup. We'll get to our starting lineups here in just a moment. And again, the winner of this one heads into the semifinals against Sioux Falls Christian. We'll have our final four set in just moments. Here's Al Bahi.
Good evening, basketball fans. Welcome to Brookings and welcome inside the Dakota Bank Center. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, Dakota Bank, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, ABC Rentals, Lake Area Tech, and the South Dakota Army National Guard welcome you to this quarterfinal game of the State A Girls High School Basketball Tournament. Our final game of this quarterfinal round will feature the visiting team on the scoreboard, the T-Area Lady Titans, taking on the home team on the scoreboard, the Flandreau Flyers. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of our high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you will enjoy the game and support these athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Before we meet the starting lineups, let's introduce the cheer teams for each squad, starting with the visitors, the T-Area Lady Titans. Cheer coach, Katie Peterson. Cheerleaders are Amory Mosley, Sophia Dodd, Nicole Fechner, Michaela Sani, Piper Statfeld, and Summer Honke. Now let's meet the cheer squad for the Flandreau Flyers. Cheer coach, Jennifer Sundermeyer. Cheerleaders are Mackenzie Gregory, Clara Kelm, Maya Nichols, Annabella Olinger, Brianna Ramirez, JC Sundermeyer. We will introduce tonight's starting lineups in alternating fashion, starting first with the visitors, the T-Area Lady Titans. For the Lady Titans, a 5'4 senior, number 2, Maya Weber. For Flandreau, a 5'11 senior, number 10, Lily Klein. For T-Area, a 5'5 senior, number 3, Hayden West. For Flandreau, a 6'2 eighth grader, number 20, Morgan Shepherd. For T-Area, a 5'11 senior, number 10, Mara Grant. For Flandreau, a 5'8 junior, number 22, Sadie Iatt. For T-Area, a 5'6 sophomore, number 11, Ellie Clayburg. For Flandreau, a 5'11 senior, number 30, Lizzie Pavlis. For T-Area, a 6'1 senior, number 23, Katie Vasica. For Flandreau, a 6'2 senior, number 32, Claire Shepherd. Assistant coaches for T-Area are Scott Bindy, Sarah Van Locken, and Bethany Vandegreen. Assistant coaches for Flandreau are Jesse Giles and Brian Relf. Head coach for the T-Area Lady Titans is Adam Shoresman. Head coach for the Flandreau Flyers is Megan Sievertson. The officials for tonight's game, referee Terry Duffy, umpire Terry Jastrom, umpire Brent Dirk, and the alternate official is John Rasmussen.
And we're ready for action here in our final game of day number one. Kind of a fun little jump here with two future Jackrabbits, Vasica and Shepherd. And Flandreau will control the tip. Pavlis has it tipped and then taken away. Last touch by T as Shepherd goes to get it. Swing it around.
Pass just a little high. I would think she wasn't sure if it was for her, maybe.
Ball blocked down underneath by Klein. Put back no good, and a rebound taken out of there by the Flyers. Here comes Klein on the run. Shepard inside. Pavlis loses the handle. Lizzie headed off to go to Wesleyan University next year to play a little college basketball. Number 10, Lily Klein, off to be a Northern Wolf.
Yeah, I got 10, Mara Grant for Tees, also going to Dort. So we got a few players from both teams moving on.
She looks like someone who would be in a Dort uniform. I've watched them play a lot the last 4 years, 5 years, and she fits the mold of a Dort defender. She just looks like every other player that steps on the floor for them.
Nice shot.
Throwing that one up late in the shot clock, Ellie Clayburgh. First basket of the game. Klein for three, short off the front iron from the baseline, and a rebound taken out of there by T area. Quickly the other way. Grant will miss. Pavlis with the rebound. Now Shepard. Handle the point guard out there. Claire, bring it to the younger sister Morgan. To Klein, swing it to Shepard. Shepard, long three, too strong. Rebound Vasika. Now Vasika will bring it up, the 6'2 point guard. Oh. Off the head of her teammate Grant. Last touch by Flandreau, though. Well, he's got to have your head. When that best player on your team's got the ball, you never know when you might get it. BC in the basketball.
Yeah, you know, I recall one time getting hit in the head. You always learned after that to always look.
Yeah. Coach Kiner was our junior high basketball coach, and we used to do the drill where you just go lane to wing playing defense, and if you didn't see the ball, you caught one in the back of the head. And again, you only did that once, too.
Exactly.
Vasika will inbound with 14 on the shot clock. Vasika now on the wing. Shot on the way, no good. Morgan Shepard will run it down. Long pass ahead. Pavlis comes up with it in the middle of the lane, and a foul on Vasika. Katie will pick up her first personal, and Lizzie Pavlis will go to the free throw line. Terry Drastrom, longtime school administrator, in the stripes tonight with the call.
You know, the Flandreau team just running down the floor, watching them. You've got 5'11", 6'2", 5'8", 5'11", 6'2". You don't see that a lot in girls basketball.
No, and they love to compete, this group. They've been basketball junkies since they were junior high kids. We played them a couple of years ago when we were back in Class A. They beat us by four in a region game. And then we went off their schedule because we went back to Class B. Now we're playing them again next year. So if I'm not talking once in a while, I'm taking notes.
Okay,
gotcha. I got a scout going at the same time here. So. Into Vasika under the hoop. And there'll be a little body foul underneath as Shepard with the bump. Nope, they're going to call that on... Oh, Morgan Shepard.
Morgan Shepard, yep.
I guess they had a 2-in-5 chance if the Shepard did it, right?
Yeah.
Close. Vasika with the first free throw is good.
82% free throw shooter. Coach AJ will like that.
Yep. She looks like that weight room will benefit her for that next level, too. I mean, just the weight program at SDSU. She's obviously really good. Well, you put on another 20 pounds of muscle over the next year or two, she's going to be incredible.
Nice baseline cut.
There's a good move by Shepard on the baseline. Future teammate of Vasika, who we were just talking about. Last touch by Flandreau and out of bounds. Media timeout at the 4:44 mark here in the first quarter. 4-3 T area over Flandreau. Back with more on SDPB.
You live life on the move. While you determine what direction that may be, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with values. Go with friends. Go with support. Go with convenience.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
And welcome back. There you see the guy on his phone. They say he's a celebrity, local celebrity, former White River star and current Jackrabbit, Joe Seiler. I thought you were talking about the Dubrook kids right behind him were the celebrities there, Christian, but I see Joe now, so yeah, I get it. I understand now. Ooh, just about drugged that pivot foot. Way out high as West, just swinging around. The Weber skip pass. To Kleber,
oh, nice
inside,
pass.
And the give, no good. Grant couldn't get it to go, and Flandreau will come away with it. Long three, no good by Shepard. Rebound taken out of there by Grant.
Great looking shot, you know, everything right on, just kind of went down and popped right back out. Like you talked about with the rims being maybe a little bit tight.
You gotta be dead on. You don't get that extra little rattle.
Yep.
It's like putting the little rim on top at practice to make sure, you know, the rebound rim we called it, but it's more for shooting, but we use it for rebounding.
We use it for rebounding too, and we didn't like to see that on there when we walked in the gym.
No. Travel. I'm gonna call that travel. Just drug that pivot foot enough. Terry Jaston right on the call. This is a very veteran crew we got here. Terry Duffy, yeah. Terry Jastrom, Brent Dirk. Great group of officials that have been selected, you know, every year. I mean, they earn it as well throughout the season, but for this Class A tournament especially, I've seen a lot of these guys throughout the year. It's a veteran group of officials that know how to keep games in hand.
Yeah, they've done a great job in all the games that we've seen today. Mm-hmm.
Claire Shepard talking with Coach Sievertson. Can't knock anything down. I'm pretty sure she said, don't stop shooting. Find another way to score. Klein on the baseline. Off the glass, powered that up. Oh. No good, in and out. Ooh, there's going to be a foul on Pavlis. Body foul. I'm going to check that Ayat. That's Sadie Ayat. Number 22, Sadie, the 5'8 junior.
You know, it's amazing to look out here. We got 2 6-foot plus point guards battling it out on top.
Yeah, no one else even looks at each other like they should take it. They're like, yeah, you go get it. We know you're bringing it up. Up off the glass and good. Great move by Clayburg again. Ellie with her second basket. Flandreau quickly the other way. And Pavlis will lose the handle. Alternating possession arrow. T basketball. 6-3 our score. I think there's another Shepherd daughter that's a sixth grader.
Oh, wow.
So there's another one coming that they say watching her in the gym by herself, really good. I'm not trying to put pressure. I'm just saying I heard that. Her dad, Brendan, sitting straight across from us, yellow shirt, top row of the front of the lower bowl. Somebody text him and tell him I'm putting the pressure on him right now. Kick out.
And good job on AJ's part recruiting Shepherd, who's got a couple siblings coming up that might be able to continue the family tradition.
Foul called on number 30. Pavlis with her first personal. Three team fouls here in the first quarter. Lob way out top. Taken away by Lily Klein. Klein now swinging around. Shepherd off the dribble. Pull-up jumper, short rebound. Taken out of there again by Grant. She has been active on the glass. West here on the left wing. Give it off to Weber. Backdoor cut. Fasica ran right into Sadie Iyett. No foul. Iyett's just standing there. She's got it right to the spot, too, so I like that no call. Yeah, there's a collision, but it's a contact sport, right?
Yep.
Full court pressure applied here. Oh, no. I thought they actually say it was off of. I'm sorry. I thought it was off of T. It was off of Flandreau.
Well, T made it look a little different running that out of bounds play with all four of the person throwing it in out of bounds, but the other four at half court.
We used to call that Philly. Got it Philly? From Jason Christensen back in his run at Mount Vernon when he was there. They used to run that and get threes at the top of the key all the time.
We play a few teams at eighth grade level with that play.
Yep. Do they kneel down and bark too? Because sometimes that works.
I call it the sucker play. I said, don't go out there and guard them.
Yeah, leave them out there. On the baseline. West, give it up to Grant. Little jumper, no good. Rebound, Pavlis. Now Pavlis will push Shepherd. No bounce and get it ahead to Klein to the lane.
Oh, strong move, though.
Yeah, two hands on the ball.
I think there are four.
Well, yeah, with both players, for sure.
Both players still was able to get a shot off, though.
Zika will send it. Left wing, West, three-pointer,
nice
got it. Hayden West with the triple. It's 9-3, T area by six. Rough offensive first quarter for the Flyers.
Was that her first basket of the game?
It was. Pavlis for three, too strong. Rebound, Shepherd loses the handle. .9 seconds to play in the opening quarter.
How about 4 seconds? We'll see what they decide to kind of go for the last one and force Flandreau to try to score in 4 seconds, or
maybe take it down about that 8 second mark at least. You know, kind of like you would on a game clock, but a little fake pressure coming there from Flandreau. Wow, put the eighth grader on the all-stater. Morgan Shepherd trying to keep up with Vizica. The miss with eight on the shot clock now. Or on the game clock.
Oh, nice pass.
The lead ahead off the glass and good for Iyett. Sadie Iyett with the lay-in to make it 9-5. That's a big basket mentally, I think, for Flandreau.
Yeah, big bonus going into the break here.
Becomes a four-point game after one quarter of play. 9-5, the 6-seed T over Flandreau. We're back with more on SDPB.
You've worked hard to build your business, your reputation, your success. Your financial partner should be committed to digging in, to drive your vision forward. For 130 years, we've stood by South Dakotans. We've been there, we'll be there. Convenient, connected, committed. Bank West, member FDIC.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live, where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
And we're back inside the Dakota Bank Center. There you see Beach Night. Hawaiian theme, whatever you want to call it, for the T Area Titan faithful. Reminder coming up, we will have a quick conversation. I think we're going to have to do it this way, by the way, Christian. Quick conversation with our coach at the end of this quarter. Quick two-minute break, and then back for the Band of the Day presentation. So we'll tell Mr. Swartis we'll do that about the five-minute mark as Shepherd puts one in to get things started in the second quarter.
That's about that's a great 10 seconds for Flandreau. They score at the end of the quarter, score right away. Nice play at the beginning of the quarter.
Three on the way, and the answer from Ellie Clayburgh. Clayburgh's got seven.
Big basket for T.
Yeah,
come
huge.
Down and answer.
Especially when Flandreau comes off of a bucket late in the quarter, then they start it the next quarter with the basket. And the answer with the three to keep that 5-point cushion. Claire Shepherd, turnaround, 16-footer, got it. That's a tough shot.
Guess we'll be seeing a lot of that in the next few years.
I would think so. She can stroke it pretty good. She's really become more athletic. I think she's found the weight room a little bit.
Yep.
I remember as a sophomore, she was just a lot thinner and fine with the run out.
Great job getting down the court and recognizing that and passing the ball ahead.
Just like that, 12-11. Vasika will give it up. West, Hayden, cross court. Weber, back to West. Off the dribble, West turns the corner, and Shepherd says, not today.
Comes out of nowhere.
That's good help defense. Watch this.
Yeah.
Help side. Oh, here she comes. We'll get that out of here.
Probably wasn't even really her help, truly.
No,
but
she dropped two spots,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, she covered a lot of ground.
16 seconds on the shot clock. Oh, Grant got loose inside, and
nice
pass. Backdoor cut. Just into the game, number four, J.C. Babb. And she's able to make the layup. Klein for three on the way. No, off the front iron. And a run out, 4-on-1. Here come the Titans. May have gotten away with the walk. Slid that foot, but they're going to call that part of the motion going up.
Good hesitation, though. Let the defense go sliding by and...
Just watch that fly by and then lay it up nice and easy.
Yep. Too many times you see kids try to force that up with the defensive person right there.
Claire Shepherd. 6 points in the quarter, 8 in the game. It's a 16-13 game, just like that. A little better second quarter for both teams. T shooting 43%, Flandreau 36% for the game. T's got a couple of triples. Flandreau yet to hit from the three-point line. Touched. Saved there by Babb. Grant, spin move, no. And then she's gonna climb over the top and a foul on Mara Grant.
You know, Flandreau's doing a great job on T's top two scorers. Grant hasn't scored yet, and Vasika only has two.
Yeah, and then Vasika's a 20-plus point per game scorer,
yeah.
So.
Grant's right there with 15.
And it's not like she's missed a ton of shots, like she's just, you know, she hasn't even taken a field goal yet. She's 2-for-2 from the free throw line and hasn't taken a field goal yet, hasn't even shot the basketball. They're gonna call the travel. Boy, that was a good looking jump stop, I thought.
I thought so too.
That's a move she'll get away with in college.
Right.
In high school, you gotta land at the same time or it's a travel. That's just what they're gonna call, which is right. But in college, they call it the other way.
Right.
Jump stop 2 feet and take a step, automatic travel. It's just
then
weird
you get to
me.
NBA, you get an extra step.
Well, you
anyway.
Get 14 then. Yeah. Step back, drag, step through is kind of the best move in the NBA right now. West on the top of the key. Looking for Vasika. The eighth grader Morgan Shepherd playing good defense. Vasika got away that time. First jumper, no good. Pavlis runs it down. 16-13, still our score. T by three. Shepherd crossover to the lane, jump stop. Didn't pick the foot up, that's why it wasn't travel that time.
Nice
in the
pass.
Lane, Pavlis off the glass, got it with the left hand.
We got a 1-point game.
4:20 to play in the quarter. Up top now is Babb. Long skip pass. Bindi, who checked in. Anna, the 5'7 sophomore. Lob inside, up off the glass, no good. And a foul coming. Terry Jastrom will come over and whistle. who it goes to. 10. White 10, Lily Klein picks up her first. Masika will have two free throws when we come back with 4:01 to play in the second quarter. We're back with more on SDPB.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
And we're back inside Dakota Bank Center in Brookings as we go to the free throw line. Katie Vasika will have the two free throws. After that foul on Lily Klein. You know, there's another thing, you get the big video board behind that sometimes for shooting. Now, right now it's dark, so that's awesome. On a free throw, they kind of shut it blank. But there are times in the middle of a game where all of a sudden you see that flash. And again, I know it sounds nitpicky, but it's just different. It's just different for shooters.
Yeah, I won't mention arenas, but there's a few I remember we'd go to play at. And when we were shooting at the end, it wasn't black. When the other team, when they shot at the end, it was.
But yeah, weird, huh?
I won't mention the arenas that we played in that did that. But
really? You won't say anything about Vermillion, huh?
Yeah.
North Dakota State, maybe? I don't know.
Well, I'm talking when I was coaching high school.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Some high school arenas that had that. And, you know, maybe they didn't have the person to man it for a half. I don't know.
In and out and back in off the glass for number 10, Mara Grant. 19-15. A 10-10 quarter right now. Both teams with 10 points in the second quarter have both outdone their first quarter output. But again, low scoring games. You just, you know, Sioux Falls Christian proved you can get up and down on the long three. Is that Clayburg again? It was.
Clayburg, yes.
Her second triple.
She's got 12 points, averaging 9.5 on the season. So she's really stepped up in the absence of Vasika and Grant not being real productive yet. I can't imagine we'd go the whole game.
22-15 our score. I was going to say, Sioux Falls Christian proved that you can, you know, play some full court style and win in the state tournament. But at the same time, if you can't play half court in postseason, a lot of times it's just hard to win. You have to be able to play half court basketball.
Yep. You know, around this, out in Rapid City, we got Harding County ahead of Lyman, 34 with 1 minute left in the third. And double A, Harrisburg defeated number 2 Mitchell.
Lyman just went ahead, by the way.
They just went ahead, all right.
Dan Swartis has it on next to me.
Oh, yeah, you can watch it. Spearfish is up by 1 over Brandon Valley, number 3 seed.
Tell you what, I love that court, the monument, though. Yeah. That's beautiful, isn't it? Again, when we come back right at halftime, I will go do the coach interview. We'll take 2 minutes and then come back and do the band of the day. So Dr. Swartis will hand that off to McCook Central, his former school, by the way. Kind of cool. He gets to do that. Lily Klein, 3. No, they're going to say touching that line. Lily Klein for 2. Coach Kruger probably watching in somewhere. If she's not here, she's watching online, I would say. And her future Northern Wolf with the second basket of the night for her. Sadie Iyap for Flandreau, I should say. Her second personal. T will take it out under their own basket. Only the second team foul of the quarter for the Flyers.
Yeah, pretty clean game. You know, T's only got 1 foul as we say that.
And now they pick up their second, and they both been Grant in this quarter.
Yeah.
Both on offensive rebound fouls, which as a coach you go, okay, you know, I'll take an offensive rebound foul. The first one was maybe a little silly. She kind of came in and smacked over the top. That was just a hard-fought battle for that one. Wrong spot, wrong time kind of thing. Five-point game. Flandreau with the basketball and the turnover. Basika against Shepard, one-on-one. Basika got it. Went with the right hand and laid it up.
Reverse, yeah, not really a reverse.
Scooped it kind
of. Kind of a reverse on the other side.
5'6 girl does that and they don't make it. A 6'2 girl does it and it goes in. Shepard for three, too strong. I was looking around to see, I haven't seen Coach Johnston. I'm not sure if AJ's in the building. Probably, I would think, with all his players. He doesn't need to be in Sioux Falls yet today. Good.
Nice pass.
Really give and go, and a great entry as Grant lays it in. Patience at the post, and then the dive to the block or the middle of the lane to get that easy lay-in. 26-17. Klein for three, got it, Lily Klein. I like Flandreau in there. Every time somebody makes a basket, they turn to the person that threw it. So just a little look. It doesn't have to be a showboat. It's just good pass, you know, that kind of thing.
Goes a long ways.
Stay together, play together, win together, right? Isn't that what they say? Something like that. On the dribble drive, Weber kicks it out. Basika being guarded by Morgan Shepard.
Long three.
Basika for three, no good. Morgan Shepard, I'm not sure she's even looked to touch it on offense yet. She's just concentrating on playing defense so hard on Basika.
Yeah.
That's buying into what coach wants you to do.
That's a big, that's a, you know, for an eighth grader coming into this game and drawing, you know, T's best player to have to guard. That says a lot about her defensive abilities.
Back-to-back threes for Lily Klein, and it's a three-point game just like that, 26-23. Flandreau faithful. Basika going to try to hold for the last shot or real close to it.
Flandreau fans on their feet trying to cheer on their defensive on the end of things.
Again, we'll get that remote mic turned on, and I'll go have a conversation with Coach Shoresman.
Nice basketball by Basika. Puts her at 7 for the game. Klein trying to go for that third three to end out the half.
Yeah, what a great look. Basika with that big bucket late to make it a 5-point game. We'll catch Coach Shoresman on his way out here, and then we're going to take a quick break. Coach, great first half. Boy, this is a dogfight. Two heavyweights going at it right now.
Yeah, absolutely. And we kind of knew that, too. You know, some familiar faces out there and stuff, and they're a really good team. They're a really good team, and they're battling.
Talk about your team and the patience. You've played through some things. Grant and Basika haven't really even gotten going yet.
No, and that's the beauty of the, you know, way we play is that we're going to have our supporting cast, and, you know, the Vasikas and the Mara Grants of the world, they're going to get theirs. So we kind of figure they're going to key on them a little bit more, and we need those other girls to step up.
Appreciate the time. Best luck second half. Adam Shoresman, the head coach for T Area. They lead 28-23. We're going to take 2 minutes and come back to hand out a plaque of the day for the band of the day today here on SDPB.
We hope you're a fan of stories about heroes, because we'd like you to meet a few of ours. These folks keep our communities moving forward. They're dedicated to being here for you, navigating change, keeping you secure, and offering a helping hand to those who need it. Heroes come from many walks. Ours are here to walk with you. Go with trust. Go with people. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great. Like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
We're all going somewhere. Going higher, faster, farther. Going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring. Keep making memories. Keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
First Dakota is here for the shared community experiences, the competition, long-standing rivalries, the players and coaches, seeing friends again, and cheering on our favorite teams. It's what makes life great here, and First Dakota is here for it.
And back inside Dakota Bank Center, I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Lisa Bahi, and again, a good run by Flander to get back to it. But now T leads. Let's throw it up to our Band of the Day performance.
We would like to direct your attention to the area in front of the band. The tournament band that has been playing for today's session of the state basketball tournament is from McCook Central High School under the direction of Austin Herbolt. In appreciation for the fine music and entertainment the band has provided throughout the day, Mr. Dan Swartos of the South Dakota High School Activities Association is now presenting to Austin Herbolt, director of the McCook Central Pep Band, a plaque to commemorate the day. Thank you, McCook Central High School Pep Band.
Very good. Thank you, Al. We appreciate that. And congratulations to McCook Central being selected to be here. Elise, let's talk real quick about this first half. You got some stats.
Yeah, you know, T area shooting 48%, 11 of 23. But Flandreau shooting 10 of 21 for 48%. So both teams even on that. Flandreau does have 9 turnovers in the half. And looking at leading scorers, Lily Klein, 10 points off of a 4 of 9, 2 of 5 from the three-point line. Claire Shepherd has 8. And for T area, you have Ellie Clayburg, who has 12 points. Mara Grant, maybe not getting her points, but also leading on 4 with 4 rebounds on the 13 to 11 rebounding advantage for T area. One of the biggest ones, offensive turnovers. T area is capitalized on 9 points, Flandreau 2, and then T area bench points, and Flandreau has not subbed yet.
And they don't sub a lot. Yeah, they're a Fab Five kind of thing.
Yeah.
They do have a player they use that will bring in and see a little bit of time, and I would think you may see her in this third
right.
to give Morgan Shepherd a quick break because she's done such a good job on Fasica. Quick break on the way back to talk with Megan Sievertson of Flandreau as we come back here on SDPB.
It's time to focus on you, a healthier you. It's time to get back to better health. Regular visits with a primary care provider at Sanford Health can lead to better overall health and wellness. It's time to get back to regular care. It's time for a healthier you and better health. It's time to see your doctor at Sanford Health.
Goodness. Seriously?
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour, you know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal.
All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, We are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actagra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do. And that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Class A girls basketball state tournament action at the Dakota Bank Center here in Brookings. I'm Brad DeBeer, joined by Megan Sievertson, the head coach at Flandreau. And coach, down five here, rough offensive effort maybe a little bit in that first half. Just couldn't get the ball to go down. Had good shots.
Yeah, we had good looks, and that's what I told the girls in the locker room at halftime. You know, some of it is playing in a state tournament. Some of it is a new place. I thought we did a little better job of settling in the second quarter, and I told them just to keep attacking.
Their two leading scorers, Grant and Vasika, having a tough time going. Credit to your defense.
Yeah, we felt comfortable with our game plan going in defensively. We let maybe Clayburgh get a few too many open looks, knowing that she is such a good shooter. But, yeah, I was happy with our defensive effort.
Key for your team the second half.
Continuing to keep them off of the offensive boards and take care of the basketball.
Best of luck. Megan Sievertson, the head coach at Flandreau. We're going to head back over to the table, get you ready for the second half, 28-23. And we'll get ready to go as T leading Flandreau. And Lisa, again, you heard both coaches talk about happy with some of the things their teams have done, but obviously things to improve on.
Yeah, you know, you look at sometimes pressing too hard, shots don't fall, but then that affects other parts of your game, where these two teams, they haven't allowed that. So it's going to be, a game all go down to the wire, like we've seen in most of the games here today.
There's some highlights, that big block from Claire Shepherd. And then the runouts, there was that one we thought maybe a drag, but a good stop, watch the flyby and lay it up. And then you see Shepherd score, Pavlis with the left-handed lay-in. There's some really good basketball in this first half. There was some missed shots, obviously, but again, state tournament basketball, you see so much better defense and the intensity level is amped up. If you've never played in this level or this atmosphere, you don't even realize how much it's amped up.
Right, you know, and the crowd getting into it, really a great draw here tonight for fans. And we knew that was going to happen coming into these games with the quality teams that we have.
Well, talk a little bit, too. When you were taking teams to state tournaments, you want to state title in AA. How do you get your kids to understand that rush of energy early in a game to kind of settle in and just get ready to play? Or you just play through it knowing the other team's maybe going through the same thing?
Yeah, I look back to that team in 2004. We were just young enough not to know the difference.
That's the beauty of it, right?
Yeah, we didn't know. Yeah. We didn't know that we were the sixth seed. You know, just it was nice. But kids have played in these moments, too.
Yeah anymore. There's so basketball. Many more big games. Yeah, it's true.
We'll see what happens tomorrow night. It seems to be a little bit more amped up. We'll talk about that later, but we got a little ways before we get to that. Thierry comes out firing no good on the shot from Weber. And now Flandreau will control. Chance to cut into that 5-point deficit. Shepherd lost the handle. She knew that going up. She kind of lost the handle and tried to shoot it anyway.
Well, shooting wasn't her first thought there.
No.
You know, she looked to the left, looked to the right. I'll take the shot. And
Hayden West splashes one in from the left side, 3-point line. Klein inside to Pavlis, back out Morgan Shepherd. Morgan to Klein, inside Pavlis, looking for the cutting Shepherd. Claire was just a step late, or the pass was a half a second late. And there's a timeout called by Megan Sievertson. Save that possession to keep it an 8-point deficit. 59 seconds into our third quarter, 30-second timeout. Check in real quick on AA and Class B with Lisa.
Yeah, Class B, we got Lyman, 46 over her number three, Hardin County, 39, 5 minutes left in the fourth. AA, we had earlier tonight, Harrisburg knocked off Mitchell, 57-41, and Brandon Valley, the third seed, up 30-18 at end of the first half.
So 1-3 seed of the three tournaments leading, the other 2-3 seeds in Flandreau and Hardin County, are down
yeah.
here in this one, this opening day of then, state basketball.
And after we are done with this game, you got Centerville versus Warner yet tonight out west in Rapid City, which is the one versus receiving votes Warner.
Yeah, that should be a dandy. Oh, yeah, that would be a 2-7 Harding County, right?
Yeah,
I'm sorry,
yep.
I was thinking 3-6. Yeah, 2-7 there. But, yeah, Warner or Centerville game should be great. Inside, Hyatt with the score. Got a chance to play Warner in the Huron Arena this year in the Huron Holiday Classic. And we played them tough. They're so athletic, long, a lot quicker than you'd think they were just watching them on film. But
well, that's the beauty of we can watch all. If you had three TVs at home, you could be watching all three of these games.
And some people are right
now. Yeah, exactly.
Hopefully they have our sound on just watching those other guys. But Christian has it. Christian Christensen, our director, right? He hasn't missed a state basketball game in 7-8 years now. He just watches every game that's played. Short off the front iron.
That's the life.
It's not a bad gig if you can get it. And then he goes back to real life and teaches third graders and uses glitter a lot in art class. Battle for the real. He loves glitter, by the way. So those of you up in the Dupree area, as much glitter as you can get to the classroom for Mr. Christensen, that'd be great. To the free throw line, kick out. Three on the way, yes! Maya Weber with her first basket of the game, and it's a three. 34-25. Shepherd in and out, no good. Rebound.
Nice rebound.
Pavlis up and good with the left hand again. Doing the dirty work, gun to the basket. Five in the game for Pavlis. Vasika up top, guarded by the eighth grader, Morgan Shepherd. Now off the dribble, a little pull-up jumper. Almost a set shot from Clayburgh. Boy, she's having a nice game. 14 in the game for Clayburgh.
Yeah, she averages about 9.5 on the season. Three rebounds.
There's always an X factor.
Yep.
Every state tournament, who's it going to be?
Well, Coach was talking about, you know who you need to isolate and take out of the game, and then who is it that's going to step up and fill that role?
Vasika on the run out, leaves it on the left side, up off the glass, and good. On the run is Hayden West, and it's 38-27. Landrew inside, Lily Klein off the glass, no good, gets her own rebound. Battle on the baseline, now Pavlis step through, no good. Pavlis gets it back. We'll have shots when we come back. Terry Duffy will tell us that the foul is on. He's trying to see a number behind a ponytail. Foul is called on, yes, we are, number 10, Mara Grant, as the media timeout. We'll take a break. We're back in just 60 seconds on SDPB.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
Back out of the media timeout to free throws once again as Lizzie Pavlis will go to the free throw line. That foul was called on Mara Grant. Grant picking up her third personal. We'll see if that weighs in here as we get going. Now they only have her listed as two. Check the board when we come back out of this.
T area shooting 62% from the three-point line.
And both free throws missed. Tied up, alternating possession arrow stays Flandreau basketball. So Grant did pick up that foul, but it's just her second. So I had an extra one in there for her somewhere. Somebody else has got one that I didn't have, but we'll figure that out when we need to. Found it. It was Weber. Not that Grant and Weber are even close in size. I'm not sure how I missed that one, but
sometimes.
I may have just marked it in the wrong spot. You know, adult ADHD is tough for me. I'm all over the place. I'm squirrel. It's just tough. So. On the dribble, Fazika, kick out, left wing.
Well, there were some moments there. It was pretty up and down.
That's true.
You know.
Now, if you look away, you're going to miss something here at times in this one. Three off the front iron, rebound by Morgan Shepherd. Now Claire will push ahead, Lily Klein. One on three, step through off the glass. Got it, what a move.
Great
Lily
move.
Lily Klein.
Step through, non-traditional, off the wrong foot, but able to knock that one down. Tough shot.
Just make plays, however you can make plays, right? Vasika step through. She'll do the same.
Yep.
Gonna get her body turned just enough to square up and shoot. Vasika, 7 points. And an 11-point lead still. Pavlis fouled inside. That one on Grant will be her third.
Got Hannah Kroll going to be coming in the game for Flandreau.
So finally going to see a sub, first sub of the game for Flandreau. That foul on Grant puts Pavlis back at the free throw line once again. And then we're going to have a 60-second timeout taken by T area. They want to get everybody to the bench and talk things over. High school basketball, a huge part of what represents our communities and towns of South Dakota. Saturday, March 9th, join SDPB as we take you on a journey into some of the stories, players and teams that surround your basketball courts in the Mount Rushmore State. From honoring a longtime coach to a student manager whose skills extend to a much different kind of court. Also, we'll meet with a player turned coach and see how one student athlete has dealt with a unique disability. All of this and more on this year's Tales from the Hardwood. This program will air live after the championship game Saturday, March 9th on SDPB1 TV. And you need to check that out, Tales from the Hardwood. Such a great program project by SDPB and the folks that work there. Everybody that is in part of this, putting high school sports out in front of people. They've done such a great job since SDPB has taken this over and moved this thing forward, getting these kids on TV. And I know before I started doing this, I was the one sitting at home watching it all the time. And
right. And, you know, you can remember watching, you're like, who's gonna be on TV this year?
Yeah, that's exactly right. So, again, thank you to SDPB for giving us the opportunity to be here and bring you the action, 40-29. Pavlis misses another free throw. At the free throw line, Lizzie is 1 of 4. Check that 1 of 5. That might be 1 of 6. And then Shepherd puts it back.
Able Shepherd to get around and get really good defensive or rebounding position there. Shepherd was able to.
Clayburg on the right baseline against Hyatt. Vasika, top of the key. Right wing now. Short pass kick out to number 13, Reese Hammerquist, who checked in. Clayburg, that's going to be no call.
No call. Couldn't quite get through that.
Yeah, she tried to step through.
They closed that down.
I kind of like that no call. I mean, if I'm coaching, I'm asking for a charge, no doubt. But from here, it's a nice no call, really.
Big, long possession for T, getting the offensive rebound.
Down to 2:42 in the quarter. Last touch by Kroll. And then Morgan Shepherd will come back in. And Hyatt will get a break. So good way to get some other people, just a short break. Came in for Shepherd, for Morgan, gives her a break. Now Kroll will stay in so Hyatt can get 30 seconds to a minute.
Yeah, you know, Flandreau has six players that get over 400 minutes on the season. So,
Goodness. That's amazing. That's a crazy number, isn't it?
Yeah.
And that's, you think about that, they've won some games big this
right.
year, so they're still
right.
playing a lot of minutes. Klein, no, missed everything.
Yeah.
Pavlis with 20 on the shot clock. Krull off the left hand to Shepard, to Claire Shepard now. Good dive, Pavlis in the paint, and a foul gonna be called on Bazika. That'll be Katie's second personal, and Pavlis will go back to the free throw line yet again. Pavlis at the free throw line, 1 of 6. See if Lizzie can get on track. This time, a little more arch on her shot,
yeah, little,
but left
yeah,
it short.
Left a little bit short. I can relate a little bit to being up there, and you're thinking about that last, the last time you were at the free throw line, and you gotta, gotta find a way to put that out of your mind. There it is.
Yep. Sometimes it just takes one, but getting to that one.
Yep.
Fighting that mental monster in your head.
Especially on this stage.
Good hands, Pavlis with the takeaway. Now Claire Shepard will look to run just a little bit. Shepard with the left hand down the lane, and that's gonna be blocked. Tried to go up and under with that right hand. Referees just aren't gonna give you that foul call that often when it's not
right.
a real good attack to the basket. There's gonna be a travel. Terry Jasher even showed the dance move with the feet there as he was doing this. He did a little dance move. I like it, Terry.
A little icky shuffle, maybe.
That, yeah. The Terry two-step, is that what they call it? I'll have to ask him afterwards. I hope we got video of that. Blocked out of bounds. Masika on Shepard. They've moved Claire inside.
Yep. Yeah, that's just a tough shot to get off when you got Masika right there with her height, her range, with her wingspan to try to do a scoop shot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got to be strong into her, at least try to draw that contact. Klein with the short three.
That's where you got to find that hook shot.
Masika showing some speed.
Stop and pop.
That would be why she's recruited to the next level at Division I. But see how fast she got at 6'2"? Yeah. That's quick.
Well, when you're 6'2", you got a lot longer stride.
Oof. Defense. 50 seconds to play in the quarter.
Pavlis is doing a great job of finding her way to the free throw line.
Third personal on Katie Vazika. Pavlis back to the free throw line again. Left it short. 1 of 7 in the quarter from the free throw line for Pavlis. 2 of 9 on the game.
You know, typically about a 69% free throw shooter. Just struggling tonight from the stripe.
Yep, just can't get it to go. 2 of 10. Vasika changes gears. And then off the glass, no good. Foul on Morgan Shepard.
She was going to try to find her way to the free throw line also. Vasika is about an 82% free throw shooter.
Vasika with 9 in the game. Check that. Yeah, 11 in the game.
How many free throws has T shot this for the game?
T on the night is 3 of 4, make it 4 of 5.
Flandreau's 2 of 10, and all of those are by Pavlis.
Yeah, she's the only one that's been at the free throw line. Shepard turnaround jumper on the baseline. Good shot.
Great job filling down to the short corner, being able to give and find the open spot, and them being able to find where she's at.
Foul called on Lily Klein, her second personal.
Lily Klein's mom, Amy LeBrun, playing at Dakota Wesleyan.
Yeah,
we got quite a few players here that have had moms and dads
yeah,
go on
Amy
and play.
Amy was a great player in high school.
For Flandreau, I believe.
Yep, she was a Flyer. And going 1-for-2 is Hayden West. 22 seconds to play in the quarter. 44-34, T has controlled this third quarter. Good dump down. Or dump back, if you will. Lily Klein with the put in. Klein's got 14. Basika, long three, no. And that will go out of bounds with 1/10 of a second. We'll wait, gonna have to inbound, can't get a shot, so we'll just touch it, start the clock, and go to our third quarter. 44-36. As the number 3 seed Flyers down 8, headed into our final 8 minutes. We'll take a break. We're back with our final quarter in moments on SDPB.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
From inside Dakota Bank Center, on the right side of your screen as you look at it, Katie Fazika on the left, Claire Shepherd, 32 and 23, both wearing the yellow and blue of the Jackrabbits of South Dakota State next season. Two of three players in this tournament that will be on campus here in Brookings at South Dakota State.
Yeah, and both these being over 6 foot point guards for both their teams. Be interesting to see where they fit in, what role they have them play.
Yeah, I would say they're probably that 2-3 type person. Yeah. Again, the Jacks with on the line there on the baseline. I thought they were calling a foul. The Jacks with the injury-riddled season they had this year, still going undefeated for the second year in a row in the Summit League, have all those players coming back.
Right.
Lose what, one or two seniors? Just one, right?
One senior.
Yeah,
one
big senior, obviously, and Torrey, but you're bringing a lot of kids back. Is there going to be enough basketballs for AJ?
I don't know, and you just think about the experience that some of those kids got this year.
I know.
He's going to have a nice problem on his hands.
Yeah, not a bad problem to have when you can go 12, 13 deep and not even bat an eye next year. Got a battle in Rapid City. Lyman up 3 with 5 seconds to play.
Harding County having chances, too, with some free throws here with the clock stopped. Great
tip away. 6-point game, and Flandreau with the possession here, a chance to cut it to 3. Morgan Shepherd thought about it. Skip Lily Klein back to Claire Shepherd on the right baseline. Back out to Morgan. Klein up top as it tips, and last touch, look out. Yeah, gonna say that was touched by number 3 Hayden West. I don't know, that's one of those that Terry Duffy doesn't win. If he calls it the way he did, the blue and yellow are yelling. If he calls it the other way, the purple and yellow are. He was right both ways, and he was wrong both ways.
Yeah, those are the type of calls you really don't want to have to make, but got to call it one way or the other.
Klein in the baseline, last touch. Look out, bodies on the deck again. Tipped away by the Titans. Flandreau being just a 20-minute drive to the south. Boy, they have really represented here in Brookings tonight.
Yeah.
Well, T's got a big contingent of fans behind us, too, and we're just only an hour away.
tees last year in this in A. They'll be double A next year.
Lily Klein with the putback. 6 1/4. 16 in the game, and it's a four-point game, 44-40 for the number 3 seed and undefeated Flyers. Weber to Vasika. Vasika looking at Grant, can't get it in. Grant wants the basketball at the high post. Now we'll get it one-on-one with Shepard. Doubled up as Klein gave help. West, pretty good defense.
Yep.
Vasika with the left hand up and good. Just a little nudge.
A little nudge, a great job. She controlled the contact. Sometimes, you know, if you control that contact, you have a better idea of going up and making the shot.
Shepard to Morgan Shepard now, out top. Morgan to Claire. Left hand down the left side to Pavlis, tipped away.
Trying a little too hard to force it inside.
Yeah, and it was probably the right place to go if you bounce past that one. Try to throw it over the top, it's just too easy to tip away. Grant probably goes right through Pavlis again for a foul if you throw it down low. There's a mishandle.
Clayburg coming back in for J.C. Babb.
.503 to play. Next dead ball will be immediate timeout. 46-40. What a great luxury for Megan Sievertson to have Brian Ralph on her bench as an assistant.
Yeah.
He's been around for so long, been a head coach. One of the best guys in the business. That's just all there is to it. 4:40 remaining. 46-40. Vasika top of the key. We'll have another stoppage of play on the next dead for the media timeout. That'll be our last. And then through the hands of Grant again. Boy, Flanders had chances. Morgan Shepard to Claire, three-pointer. No good. Rebound inside. Iyett. Sadie Iyett with the putback.
She just comes out of nowhere to grab that and put that back in.
Again, just the desire, the heart to go get an offensive rebound. Under 4 to play. Out top, Clayburg. Haven't heard from her in a while. And out of bounds. Now we'll go to the media timeout with 3:48 to play. We'll take a break. 46-42. T. Hilbert Flandreau back with more on SDPB.
It's time to focus on you, a healthier you. It's time to get back to better health. Regular visits with a primary care provider at Sanford Health can lead to better overall health and wellness. It's time to get back to regular care. It's time for a healthier you and better health. It's time to see your doctor at Sanford Health.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
From Dakota Bank Center and Brookings, South Dakota, the Class A State Girls Basketball Tournament. 3:48 to play. Here's that wild set under their own basket and bring everybody to half court. That's the exact set that Jason Christensen used to run with the Phillies.
Lily Klein reaching in, able to tip that away for the Flandreau Flyers.
Three-pointer, Shepard, no. Rebound again, tipped out, saved by Pavlis. skip pass. Basika, look out. What are they going to call it on? They'll call it on Basika. T-Fan's not happy about it. There was a definite collision.
There was a collision.
I think whatever the vantage point of the official making that call, that's where it was going to go.
Right.
Basika was on the inside. And if the referee's on the inside, he might think she had the advantage. But regardless, another one of those that I wouldn't want to call.
Yeah.
Pavlis. And that the big thing is Basika's fourth. She's got to back off a little bit on defense now. Lily Klein against the 2-3 zone of T. Shepherd in traffic.
Tough
no.
Shot.
Tipped around. Taken out of there by Pavlis again. Oh,
great
good
hands.
Takeaway by, was that Weber?
I think that Weber got a piece of that, knocked it off to, knocked it back to Vasika.
Maya Weber.
Weber listed as 5'4".
That's stretching it. That's with lifts
that's
in her shoes.
Yeah.
Although out there with all the 6-footers, she might be. She just looks
she might
smaller.
Be. 5'4", you got
Grant with a step back on the baseline. Mara Grant with her sixth point of the game, and it was a big one. 48-42, 2:23 to play. Claire Shepherd to Pavlis. Pavlis in the lane, no, too strong. Rebound, Basika. Flandreau has not been in this position very often, if at all, this season. Down to 2 minutes almost to play in the game, and they trail by two possessions. Inside, Grant can't come up with it. Jump ball as they come down with it. Good call, Terry Jastrom. 48-42, 2:01 to play.
Flandreau has three timeouts left. T has four.
Yeah, this could be a long 2 minutes. Here comes the first one for T. He wants a 60. Coach Shoresman going to take a look there. You got a couple of score updates, maybe?
Yeah, we do. We got a final out in Rapid City. Lyman defeating Harding County 54-49. So number three seed going down. Double A, we got Brandon Valley. 2 minutes left in the third, up 39-26 over Spearfish.
So good basketball all over the place. Again, we've had a great day here in Brookings, just like we thought it would be.
You know, out west, you still got Centerville over Warner.
We'll get to watch the second half of that one. That'll be kind of fun. SDPB, your home for the 2024 State Basketball Championships. Check out sdpb.org/basketball, where you'll find action and award photos, stories, statistics, brackets, and so much more. Visit sdpb.org/basketball to expand your hoops experience. Again, look forward to a full day of hoops tomorrow. We'll talk more about that at the end of the day here today, where we'll see Mount Vernon Plankinton and Makpaya Luda at noon tomorrow. Our 1:30 game will be Hanson taking on the loser of this one. And tomorrow night, Sisseton and Vermilion at 6 o'clock. Sioux Falls Christian versus the winner of this one in the nightcap.
We got T area shooting 50% to Flandreau 41. Big statistic, 3 points, field goal percentage. Flandreau just at 12%, 2 of 17, while T area is at 5 of 9 for 56.
And free throws, 5 of 8 versus 2 of 10.
Right.
And you trail by 6. Those are the little things that come back to haunt.
Yep.
Shepherd long 3, wide left. Blair Walsh that one. 48-42, good effort by Hyatt. Falls through the photographers and your eighth graders down there, and all is good.
You know, Hyatt just working hard, trying to get her to get the ball anytime she can.
Well, and I think Hyatt, one of those players that you would say on this team, has bought into her role. She knows what she's supposed to do the little things. You've got a Division I, a Division II, and an NAIA player all on your team.
And
you're not one of those three because you're a junior, you're an underclassman. You just do what you're supposed to do to help the team win. And
I think we're going to see Flandreau trying to get a few fouls here because they only have one.
Yeah, they're going to got the turnover.
The turnover, that's probably what you're hoping for. If you don't get the turnover, you got to look to probably get a quick foul to try to get to the free throw line.
Three for Klein, and really Klein knocks it down.
great shot.
And then the quick foul,
which
T wants a
intentional.
Terry Jastrom and Mr. Dirk are talking about it. I don't think they're going to get it. Foul call on number 20, a hold. I didn't see even what happened.
Yeah, so. I didn't either. It was real quick.
You may see it here. I don't know if we have the full replay. That was the shot, the big three. So, again, you got to make a play on the ball.
Yep.
But at the same time, in full court, a lot of times, two hands is an automatic touch foul anyway. You know, if that play on the ball is down near the basket more times than not, that's
right.
What they're going to look at.
Yep.
20.
Flandreau to three fouls. Just getting themselves in the position late in the game if you have to foul to try to get the ball back.
Yeah, three team fouls with the fourth on Morgan Shepherd.
Yeah.
Had to give it up, though. And now you can play good, solid defense. Ooh, they're going to go with another one? I don't think they wanted that away.
Yeah, I don't think Coach wanted that.
And Morgan picks up her fifth. I don't think she got the message that they didn't want to foul yet. They had, shot clock's going, you're at a minute 30, you're only down one possession. That was one where you got it to four. Now when you need it later,
right.
You're there.
Yep.
So you want to play a good, solid defense. But again, eighth grader, it's loud in here. She didn't hear it. She's just doing what Coach said earlier. We got to foul, get him to the free throw line. So.
Yeah, this is where the not having the one-on-one makes it a little difficult to try to get back in the game.
Yep. But again, it makes it so much more fun
because
it doesn't slow the game down the whole 3.5-4 minutes before that. Catch our breath a little bit here as we get the full timeout, the 60-second variety. One more check-in on our other games going on right now.
Yeah, Double A, we've got Brandon Valley. Start of the fourth period up 45-30 on Spearfish, so it's kind of pulling away. A little bit in the B's, waiting on Centerville and Warner to tip off yet.
Scotty Quaz, voice of the Jackrabbit women's basketball squad, got the triple cast going.
Oh, yeah, look at you.
That's the picture he sends, so thanks, Scooter.
Oh, that's Scotty Quaz, yeah.
Yep. Voice talent, Scotty Quaz, by the way. If you're looking for any voice talent, he's your guy. There's your free plug right there, Quaz. Someday I'll probably have to go to work for him, so I got to keep him on the good side. 48-45 to reset it here. Again, you talked about the foul situation. Flandreau with four team fouls, so the next one puts T at the free throw line. T area, just one in this fourth quarter. So if something crazy would happen, they got a long ways to fight back with fouls. So again, at 9:07, we could be here at 9:30 still waiting for this one to end with a minute 29 seconds to play.
Well, as a coach, you're looking at that, you're up by three. Do you try to, when Flandreau gets the ball, try to get a couple quick fouls just in case you get to the point where you do need to get the ball? Yeah.
I would be one who maybe dribbling up, take a chance. If you foul, you foul. Don't get beat deep. But
right.
Oh.
Flandreau wanted that one. Klein almost had that.
They were just reacting a split second late. Vasika, 23 on the shot clock.
And they can take this down to under a minute.
Yeah, 7 seconds difference between that minute time and the shot clock there. Vasika, no! Rebound by Kroll and a foul, which again.
Probably not a bad foul.
Not a bad foul at all. Except it was on Vasika. That might be her fifth.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it is.
So, the foul on Katie Vasika, her fifth personal. No, wait, they.
That is
her fifth. Yeah. He called it on 23. He brought it over and said 23. I have five. We'll see what the official book has.
Well, he's holding up five.
Well, and Steve Van Hurdy, our official book, is asking, who was it called on?
I think the question we're looking at is if it was Vasika that the foul should have been called on. I know
right.
We have replayable moments in the last, 2 minutes?
Yeah, minute, not that,
but
though,
not
just
that.
For shots.
Yep.
Just to see if it's a three or if it's a shot. Yeah, he called it on 23. He called it on 23. That's what he said. We have a timeout on the floor. So that'll be her fifth, 30-second timeout. Yeah, I think what they're asking, like the crowd is on it, saying it was on 10, which that's who they thought. The referee called it on 23. Whether it was, I mean, whether, whatever, that's what the official call was. He didn't come over and report 10.
Right.
He reported 23. That's the call. The crowd just disagrees that it was, thought it was on somebody else. That's who he had it on.
And that's not a revealable play.
No. You move on. Got the Brookings administration back here getting ready. JD's ready, chest
it's
out.
Getting a little rowdy.
We're getting JD all pumped up.
But looking back at it, not a bad foul, except for the fact that Vasika fouled out.
That was her fist, right. Yeah, on anybody else, he doesn't care, because whatever, big deal. Now you get your defense set. Still don't need a three if you're Flandreau. You need 3 points, but you don't need a three right here. Tipped around, saved by Pavlis. Look out, bodies hit the floor. Skip pass, take it away. Last touch by Flandreau. Hannah Kroll, the last to touch it.
You just feel the electricity in the gym here getting.
Timeout on the floor. Full timeout. Yeah, who said this venue wasn't going to be loud and crazy? Yeah. Plenty loud and crazy.
Flandreau's got 2 timeouts left. T has 1.
40. Yeah, let's take a look at that last touch. 42 seconds. Here's that last play out of bounds. And yeah, you can see the swipe, no doubt about it. Last to touch it. That was number 14, Hannah Kroll. Terry Duffy, veteran official. What'd I say, Pete Entringer's done it for 50 years? Terry's probably done it for 49 or 51. I don't know. They might have done it the same amount. I'm not sure, but regardless, that's a good call. There's the T faithful. Trying to get their team fired up. Again, now Flandreau does not have to foul right now. There's 7 second difference between shot and game clock. So you don't have to foul and put them at the free throw line. But if you do, where do you go? That's the conversation the assistant coaches are having. Jesse Giles and Brian Relf on the bench deciding we gotta tell who are we gonna foul if we need to.
Well, West is about a 45 or 75% shooter. Grant 60, Clayburg is about 73%. From the charity stripe.
So Grant is your go-to right now. If you're gonna have to foul, that's probably who you go at.
Well, you got JC Babb that's in the game that hasn't played a lot of minutes yet today.
And a diving foul. Hyatt trying to dive for the ball, made contact, so they elect to use the foul early.
And Clayburg, looks like she'll be going to the stripe. Maybe not the one you really wanted. She shoots about 73%.
And that one just turned into you had to because the ball was thrown over the top.
Yep.
Great job by the inbounder, though, to throw that toward their basket.
Right.
In a rush, like, I got to get rid of it. I don't want the 5 second call. At least throw it toward your end.
Right, right.
Really heady play. Clayburg, yes, on the first. 2 possession game now. Plenty of time. 41.7 seconds, 2 timeouts remaining for the Flyers.
That's a big one.
Yeah. Now a 3-pointer has to be in the mix at some point, most likely, unless you can get 3 quick twos, but you gotta be a little urgent. Pavlis, she'll shoot it from 17, no good. Rebound, Klein, and a foul gonna be called on number 2, Maya Weber. For second, again,
not bad.
You want the tie up because they have the possession, but you don't have to.
Right.
And now the chess match begins. Hammerquist comes in. Out comes Babb. Hammerquist for defense out of the 2-3 zone. Quickly. Shepherd last to touch it out of bounds. And offense for defense, back with Babb. 50-45.
Oh, good hustle.
There's a foul on Klein.
Good hustle. That's exactly what you want. Going for the steal if you don't get it, the foul.
Yeah, she's a half a step quicker. She maybe knocks that ball loose and is able to grab it. But
right.
Again, had to go through the body. Something I never thought I'd see is Rick Weber in suspenders over there or in bib overalls. But look at him. Looks fantastic. First time I noticed him tonight. He fit right in with the kids earlier.
Yeah.
No good on the first free throw attempt for Maya Weber. Horn goes, just not sure what that was for, but 21 seconds to play. Weber got it. It's a 6-point game, still two possessions, but they both got to be threes now. Shepherd, timeout. Good hustle by Shepherd to get it here quickly. And again, I think as soon as this one's over, let's try to go to that conversation with the head coach of the winning team. Then we'll take that break just to let them get in and be with their team, because I think they're going to want to be with their team and yep. not wait out here talking to us. And we'll do some highlights, do some stats, and wrap things up, get you ready for tomorrow. This one's not over yet, but it's getting closer for the Titans. 51-45, again, one timeout remaining now for the Flyers. One timeout for T area. And anything foul-wise on Flandreau puts T at the line. T has one foul to give with only three team fouls. So they do have one to give. Let them inbound it, couple dribbles and a foul, make them reset it. Take a chance on them firing a shot up on you, but if you get out there and get in them right away. Remember now, Vizika fouled out with just, just under 2 minutes to play in this game. They'll inbound it right here in front of us at the table. Lily Klein, the future Northern Wolf. Or is it Northern Wolf? She'll be a part of the pack either way. Lily will inbound to Iyett, swing it around, crawl. Shepherd, now Klein follows her. Three off the backboard, no good. That's a great inbound
play. Great inbounds play, yeah.
You can't guard two people out of a 2-3 zone in the corner.
Right.
So you bring Shepherd and fling it one more time, the extra pass. I like it. 11 points. See, I'm just scouting. Yeah. 11.6.
You take a little half second longer. Probably had a better aim at
yeah,
that.
Yeah, kind of shoot it so
released a little too quickly.
Well, and you know that you got to be urgent. You got to be quick with it. And here comes the dagger free throw, if it goes, for Ellie Klaberg. She'll get two, make it a three-possession game, and with 10.6 to play, that is pretty tough. But you got to make one first. Yep. What a great first day of basketball here in the Dakota Bank Center for us.
Yeah, it's been great sitting here. One of the best seats in the house.
And that makes it seven. This number six seed looking to advance. And that one falls short. Shepherd up with two. And a timeout. Going to be called with 1.9 to play. And it looks like Flandreau will suffer loss number one on the season. The Titans will pick up win number 20 on the season. And the big thing is T will advance to the state semifinals tomorrow night. The dream run for the Flyers coming to a close here. Again, This is state championship game level basketball that we've seen in this game. And if we get this good of a championship game Saturday night, well, we got to count our blessings because this has been fantastic.
Yeah, you know, you got a T coming in at 19-4 with two of those losses being to double A schools. You play two A schools, win, you might not be the sixth seed.
Right.
But this, like you talked about, a championship level game right here between these two teams.
And again, we'll talk about it tomorrow. It's how do these teams respond because they still get two more games. And
yep.
That says a lot about the character of these teams and coaches and kids. So,
especially coming into the consolation bracket.
Yeah.
To having to regroup and come out and still play for something.
And that'll do it. The T-Area Titans will advance to the state semifinals. We're going to flip it over to the remote mic.
And as we do that, I will make my way down the benches and catch up with the head coach of the T-Area Titans, Adam Shoresman. As they